Good morning. Good morning. This is the Opie and Anthony program on XM Satellite Radio. Hi. It is a virus. It's spreading across America. It's slowly spreading to Canada.
Yeah, it's up there.
Soon to be heard in Iraq. Wow.
I think in a limited capacity, we're already there.
No, they're already listening to us in Iraq.
I want
to say hi to the boys.
Doing their thing. What happened to you over there?
My club soda exploded. It went goosh in my face.
I don't know anyone, by the way, that drinks club soda as much as you.
It's great for my voice. I hear it's really good for the voice. And it's very good to drink water all day long.
All day long. So why don't you just drink bottled water?
Because the bubbles tickle my throat.
Ugh.
Now, the bubbles are good, and it's like it helps me talk the whole day. I found nothing better than club soda to drink during the day.
Mmm, bubbly goodness.
Is this good, Steve?
And it makes me burp.
Above average? All right, above average. Good.
Less than soupy diarrhea.
Steve is running in here with all the audio from the fans. What about the drunk stuff? They're starting to come in? Drunk audio?
Some, yeah. I have like maybe 8 pieces of it.
Okay, good. Good. Yeah, there's a couple bits that the listeners could have fun with. Obviously, the Emily Stern remixes. The country songs are trickling in. And now we got the drunk audio thing that is starting to take off. So that's pretty cool.
Yes.
We're all over the place. We'll explain in a second. There's like so many people outside the studio. But first, it's Jim in upstate New York. Jim?
Hey, good morning, fellas.
Good morning. Hey, what part of upstate?
I live in Lake George.
Wow.
In the lake, actually?
Well, right on the lake. Let's put it
On Lake George.
You're part of Canada.
Upscale.
Yeah.
Pretty close.
That's Canada, man.
An upscale conservative area, and I just saw my first fucking wild sticker.
That's pretty
so
cool.
I'm not the only asshole listening to you guys. You guys fucking rule. Keep rocking.
That's what's so cool about this. Every morning I say the ONA virus spreading across America, and there is a perfect example that it is spreading. Slowly but surely.
It certainly is.
That's your first sticker?
That's the first one I've seen, man. I've got one on my car, but it's the only other one I've seen.
Oh, that's very nice. Thank you, Jim.
Punching out, guys.
All right. Listen to this, where this guy listens to us. Jim in Indiana. I thought it was cool that the boys in Iraq are listening on a daily basis through the computers and stuff. Jim in Indiana, where are you listening?
I'm listening 250 feet deep in the ground. I work in a stone quarry. Ooh. We got one local radio station here that we can pick up in the hole.
But you don't want to.
No.
Oh, it's in the hole. It's horrible.
Yeah.
But I got XM Satellite, and I pick up all my channels down there. Everything works. Pisses everybody else off in the quarry.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, I worked in a shanty where I had my rig set up or my XM unit. My boss decided I was having too much fun. He put me over into a haul truck, and needless to say, my Roadie 2 went right there, and I'm still picking up all my channels and picking up XM. By the way,
it's pretty lonely down there. You got me.
Same
a little
time.
Lonely down there.
We can figure out how lonely this poor guy is in the hole.
Oh, man, it's a boring job. It's a horrible job, but it pays good money.
All right, we'll make you laugh, Jim. Thank you.
The world needs rock diggers, too, you know.
I'm spending. You still there?
Unfortunately, yes.
You still there, please?
I missed my chance to hang up on him, and now we're stuck with him. He's going to keep talking because he just needs to talk.
Poor guy in the hole.
What was that, Jim?
I'm spreading the virus. Back at Christmas time, I went to Best
Buy. Story.
Found Roadie 2s on sale for $17.95.
Yeah, that was the thing that was happening around Christmas.
Christmas. He wants to tell us about
cheap
Christmas.
Stuff was available
in the hole,
everywhere.
He talks to like granite.
Subscriptions and gave them to my boys, and I spread the virus.
All right. Say hi to Fred Flintstone for us, okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Sits on a dinosaur all day long.
Right.
Turns handles.
Well, speaking of dinosaurs, very sad news today. Very sad news. The Telegram is dead. Stop.
Stop. See,
they were getting cute with the headline.
Yep.
The Telegram is dead. Stop.
I didn't know.
Because that's what you used to do when you used to write telegrams.
I didn't know it was still around.
tell you the truth. With email, there really isn't a need for the telegram. But it was still around. Who knew? Who used? Did you ever send a telegram in your life?
Of course not.
No. Do you know anybody that ever sent a telegram?
Maybe my grandma?
Yeah. You ever
Maybe?
Received a telegram?
No.
No.
I thought it just went away years ago.
With cell phones and email, it's like...
Cell phones? I'll tell you when the telegram should have went away.
The telephone?
When we discovered the fax machine.
Oh, yeah. Well.
Isn't that kind of like a telegram machine?
No, because they couldn't even send pictures. It was just limited words, so it's kind of... Yeah, it was kind of like a hand-delivered fax or anything that could have been tied up... with a telephone call, or one of those beep, 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 beep,
yeah,
beep,
yeah.
beep, little Morse code. But for like 150 years or something, this thing's been around. And I guess it was popular back when there was nothing, but now it's done.
161-year era.
161 years.
Appeared on the internet.
So is...
Okay. The ultimate irony. The company's terse ending of a 161-year era appeared on the internet.
Oh.
So the internet...
That's where they announced it?
They announced it on the internet that the telegram is officially dead.
So what does Western Union do now? Like transfer money? Is that their gig?
I guess.
You see them like pushing that every so often that you could wire money to people. You ever wired money? Have you ever been wired money?
Well...
Doesn't that just sound shady?
Yeah, of course it does.
All right, wire me the funds. I need them wired into an account offshore.
Yeah.
And Western Union is there. Stop.
What other things have gone away since we were born? We're not that old, but now the telegram's gone.
I mean the rotary phone.
The rotary phone
is gone.
That
was one of those things. If you had to make a lot of phone calls in one day, you'd get that dent in your index finger. By your cuticle from dialing so much,
yeah.
Slamming against that iron fish hook at the end when you bottom out.
Ka-chong.
And then if you're trying to dial fast, you would keep your finger in the dial hole and go to like 9 and then pull it all the way back.
Yeah.
I'm in a hurry here. And then push button. Yeah.
Well, E-Rock came up with one, the typewriter.
The typewriter. Does anyone need or use a typewriter?
But growing up, you and I have used typewriters.
Yeah.
And now there's kids listening to us right now going, what?
Now you just pop what? Open your laptop or your computer and you got 20 different programs to choose from, print it out.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Well, Matt from Boston, his family used to send telegrams all the time. Matt?
Yeah, when somebody would have a kid or whatever, the uncle or somebody would send a telegram to the kid. So we all have one from when we were born, and now my brother and sister and I are sending them to each other.
Oh, wait.
It's just like a family tradition?
You send it to the kid.
Yeah.
So then when you get older, you're like, oh, this is the telegram that Uncle Creepy sent me when I was born.
Yeah. So now we have to go back to Morse code.
All right. Well, and it's a tradition that just lives on in your family until today?
Not anymore. It's dead, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Very exciting conversation. The telegram.
As exciting as the telegram.
Yeah, exactly.
Telegrams were always bad things, though. I think that was like, telegram was a pretty ominous thing. Unless it was something like you were waiting for a baby to be born or something like that. Usually it's like, I am sorry
to inform you. Aunt Gertrude, dead. Stop.
Yeah. Stop. Didn't they used to inform like... families of war dead that way, too?
That's probably how it began.
Greetings.
Should we get the history of the telegram?
No.
So we can really bore the listeners to sleep?
I'll probably get online at home and look that up myself just so I have the knowledge for some, I don't know, something might pop up.
No surprise there.
Later on.
Anthony, it's Super Bowl. It is going to happen today.
Super Bowl is today. It is Super Bowl Thursday, as it has been known throughout... history.
Recorded history.
Everyone. It's like an American holiday, Opie, Super Bowl Thursday. People take the day off. They gather around their radio. Family, friends, 8-foot heroes, keggers.
Yeah.
And they just want to listen to true sport. The sport of the Super Bowl.
And I think it's going to be a little scary today because we got EMTs pacing back and forth outside the studio with all sorts of paperwork. And things.
Based on this program, they should be here every day.
Every day, right.
And
then there's an ambulance
Right downstairs.
Right downstairs, waiting just in case someone has an allergic reaction today.
Yeah.
We had this creepy bug guy that that came by.
I don't know how he has so many creepy bugs.
I'll tell you why he's creepy bug guy, because he has a lot of really creepy bugs that I've never seen in my life. He decided to just bring in an array of bugs. Here
Big
he is.
Collection.
This is the guy that is saving Super Bowl so we could do the ultimate challenge. What's your name, bro?
Ken.
Hey, Ken. Nice to have you here today.
Nice to meet you guys.
Well, you want to bring some of your bugs in?
Sure.
We could have a little show and tell.
Yeah. Where are you from?
New Jersey.
Why did I know that before you said it? Creepy bug guy has to be from New Jersey.
And we can collect this stuff from most of the buildings in New Jersey.
I don't doubt that. Yuck.
Wait, like, this is your job to... What is your job?
Yeah, what's your job that you have these bugs?
We sell feeder insects nationwide to pet stores.
Oh, okay, sure.
Bait shops, that kind of thing.
So the mealworms over there would be for your reptile, your lizards, things
like that?
For lizards,
the bigger ones, the bigger, larger mealworms are for bait.
Mm. And what about the cockroaches? Why would people need these? I see them all the time on this show. For some reason, they're a staple of this program. What would people need one of those for, aside from a radio show?
Just to feed reptiles. Sometimes they keep them as pets.
Are those the hissing cockroaches?
Yeah, I have some hissers there. If you touch them, they hiss.
Madagascar.
You got to hear these things. You know what? I'm proud to say we introduced the world to the hissing cockroach.
Oh, yes.
Way before...
National Geographic.
Way before Fear Factor.
Yeah, true.
We were doing
5-gallon drums.
Yeah, we were doing things with the hissing cockroaches many, many years ago. You got to bring one of those to the mic because this is the creepiest sound.
And they're
listen to this. Listen,
E-Rock's running.
Well, listen what this thing will do when you touch it.
Oh God.
Right now, it's burrowing into my hand, too.
I see that.
That hissing
Can you find those in New York?
Yeah.
No, I'm serious. Can you find those in buildings? Like,
No.
In my apartment, I see a cockroach every once in a while, but I'll never see a hissing cockroach,
Aren't
right?
they from Madagascar?
Yeah, these are actually from Madagascar. They're just indigenous to tropical regions.
Yeah.
We're not allowed to sell these in Florida because they could live down there. If these were to get loose here, they'd only be able to live during the summer, and they'd die as soon as the temperature went down.
Right.
Like the homeless.
But just like the homeless in France.
Yeah. Oh, but somewhere in Florida, you let those go, and could be a problem.
Yeah.
Two of them get together, hook up.
Well,
the males have bumps on their heads and the females don't, so that's how you can tell them apart.
Oh, that's how you can tell?
And the males hiss, the females don't.
Yeah. Wow. They're kind of opposite of humans.
Exactly.
Where the male keeps quiet and the woman is just, yap, yap, yap.
Yeah.
Hiss, hiss, hiss. And if she does, she usually ends up with bumps on her head.
Well, I got the list of insects in front of me here. The hissing roaches, maggots, superworm beetles.
Yeah.
What's that?
These are the superworm beetles. If you touch them, they'll release a pheromone, which is an attractant, like a sexual attractant, which is something that females also do. Our females, but they have they also secrete a brown liquid that'll stain your hands. But they
so does Jimmy Norton. Now, coincidentally enough, when he's out on dates,
is that right?
Yeah.
they smell too, but these will also do like a little tickle, nibble kind of thing. Not that I've tried it, but if you were to place your stuff in there, you'd get a sensation.
Now, none of these are poisonous,
except maybe the honeybees. If you're
the bees, the bee venom,
and there they are.
Yeah,
the bees.
Now, I saw your contraption, which is very phallic.
Yeah.
Once they place their bag, I guess, in that contraption, that appendage that sticks out should be blown into. The reason for that is that the warm air will get these guys angry.
Oh, so someone has to blow into
the phallic
appendage.
Yeah, to the tip of that.
As some guy's sack is hanging in the Tupperware portion.
You know, I've been fighting this for so long, I give up. This show is gay.
What a gay show we're on.
This is a gay show. So you're telling me, as the expert, that someone has to blow into the tube to get these bees going.
Someone does, and I'm not expert enough to do that myself.
No. What is it about human breath that riles up the bees?
I don't know if it's just the heat and the moisture or the something in, instinctive in them that just sets them off.
E-Rock can't do it because it will be a bee holocaust. It'll be like the showers at Dachau.
Now, if they're I got stung by these bees. I got stung about 10 times just collecting
them.
This
is how
wait, you got stung 10 times
this
yesterday?
This is how dedicated this guy is to the show.
I love
He's the
show.
One that stepped up and said, all right, I'll get the bees for the guys. Look at his hand. It's all swollen.
Hand, my arms.
He got stung 10 times. He's allergic to bees.
And this is not fat. It's just swollen bee venom in my...
Are you kidding?
No, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'm fat.
I don't know.
What, I know. I'm like, wow, that stuff must collect in the liver. Or,
right.
What do you do to collect them?
I just went in and I just stuck a stick in, got them angry. When they came out, I brushed them into cups, and they just went all over me and started stinging. So
you got what one of those... Big box type hive
things. I have hives,
things.
Yeah. The hives you're talking about.
Yeah.
So I'm one of those guys.
How many?
I have three hives.
And what is it for? Just honey?
Just
to
pollinate. Yeah, and for honey. I would make wine out of the honey. Mead.
Really? Mead. Yes.
Yeah, it's a good old-fashioned way to get
drunk. Days of old.
How many times do you get stung a year having bees?
Nah, just a couple. But last summer... I had some go up my shorts, which is how I know these will work. And I got stung. And I have my daughters were out there, and they're little, and they just saw the bees going up. They saw me fall over on the ground screaming.
That's got to horrify the children. Oh,
no,
they were laughing?
They were laughing
That's
at
great.
Me while
kids.
I...
Kids, Jesus
yeah, I
Christ.
Thought, I thought that was done. I was it. No more kids.
All right, hold on. Ben's Raw Ass has something. Ben's Raw Ass, what's up?
Hey, yo, I want to know if this dude bought his cock-licking ball roaches.
What's that?
Cock-licking ball roaches.
That's from what I said.
Are you doing a callback of his awful line yesterday?
Yeah, I'm the awful calling guy.
Yeah.
All right, very good. Ben's Raw Ass, everyone. All right. What else is there? Anything of interest?
These are just regular German roaches. We also have some flightless fruit flies. We've bred these so that they wouldn't have wings. So if you look at them, they kind of look like ants. But they're actually fruit flies.
Okay.
And what the hell can they possibly do?
They just exist, and people feed them to frogs.
Oh, yeah?
And that kind of thing, yeah. Yeah.
What do you sell these to, pet shops?
Pet shops, bait stores, and then regular just reptile enthusiasts.
Now, obviously,
hobbies.
You brought a lot of this stuff in just for show, but can we use anything else there on the
yeah,
table except
yeah.
for the
I
bees?
Yeah, I think, like, these are super worms. You know, these are the other things that you see them eating on, like, Fear Factor and that kind of
yeah.
thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So... They stink. They'll also nibble and stuff, but they're getting a little lethargic here.
Getting a little tired.
Is it the cold?
Yeah. Oh, and just so you guys know, too, when you're ready for mosquitoes, let me know. Just give me a week's notice, and I could hatch you out a bunch of mosquitoes.
See, we thought about that way too late. We wanted to do the mosquitoes as well.
Yeah, because mosquito bites on your bag. I've never been bitten on the bag.
I would say the mosquito bite on the bag would be worse than getting stung by a bee. On the bag.
Maybe the instant pain.
Yeah, the bee more terrifying, knowing it's happening.
Yeah.
But a mosquito doing it, you know, after he's done, I think it would be much more of a problem.
And the quick pain from the bee sting, but then you have that residual itching, big bump on your nut kind of thing you got to deal with.
You got to do the whole
thing. You do the thumb and forefinger. Only a guy could know about the thumb and forefinger roll of the bag. It's you sit there like a dog scratching himself. It is wonderful.
It's the other ecstasy. That's the other ecstasy.
Oh, all right.
The other ecstasy. No,
sorry. Well, they just pulled the groundhog out of the hole. I want to go to live audio.
Phil, what did he say? He's now he talks.
I'm not getting my live audio.
Oh, my God. We need audio. E-Rock.
Let's try that.
See if it sees its shadow. Oh, my God. This just isn't right.
Well, the rodent is
Imus.
It's
on Imus.
Mortified,
this is MSNBC.
The groundhog looks like me.
Controls, ladies and gentlemen, if you give us a moment, we'll tell you which one Dr. Johnson gets to read.
It's got to be drugged, too.
Yeah,
I mean, it's horrible. I was going to be scratching and clawing.
Horrible abuse of this animal. Now look at this.
Where's the heroin?
Yeah. This is just absurd. These people should be prosecuted.
I'm so with you, Imus.
I'm so with you, Dad. I suggested I wanted to blow the rodent to smithereens with my Remington 700.
Here comes the announcement.
I don't want to do that. All right, here we go. Now, what does this mean? I shouldn't be allowed to do this, should they, Charles?
Man, this just isn't right. Where's the ASPCA?
Where's Peter?
And there used to be like 100 people that showed up. That was like thousands and thousands.
There's obviously got to be some day where you can get laid and get drunk.
Oh, here it comes.
Oh, my God. Everyone is drunk.
On Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, this Groundhog Day, February 2nd, 2006.
All right, what?
At 7:23 a.m.
What?
Groundhog President Bill Cooper has aroused Punxsutawney Phil from his long winter's nap.
And?
Punxsutawney Phil.
This guy needs a dirt nap.
Seraph Sears, weather prognosticator without peer. Fearless forecast.
What?
Lost himself gleefully into the waiting arms of his longtime friend and handler, Bill Healy.
Come on.
Well, we're waiting.
I love how impatient they are over there.
Those are your parents.
After an affectionate greeting, Bill held Phil high so he could greet his many exuberant, faithful followers and wish them a happy groundhog.
The groundhog took a dump, too.
Incidentally, Bill has set a record for kissing a groundhog more times than any other human being.
I mean, this is repulsive. This fat bastard kissing the
Bill ground. Seated Phil on top of the old oak stump where he conversed with President Cooper.
We gotta know.
Now we've been this far.
Too much.
All right, you're on.
To the appropriate scroll, which reads...
Guy's shaking, you see that?
Oh, God.
Judas. It is said that imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. Around the country, there are many imitators of me.
This guy doesn't...
In Harrisburg, there is Gus, who appears on TV, working for the lottery.
All right.
What?
We're going to lynch this guy.
Stop throwing stuff at him.
Then all around town, cute groundhog statues abound.
Like Elizabeth
they
Taylor, remember
like
that?
Me,
I'll get off in a second.
Today on the knob, as I'm doing
my
job, I don't like this likeness of me. It's my shadow, I see. Six more weeks of mild winter weather there will be.
Shoot the messenger. That fucking thing sees a shadow every year. Every goddamn
that is
year.
Tough to take.
Ain't but that America?
God, that is just. Well, there's got to be something else. Well, there is something else going on there.
Yeah, it's a big party.
Oh, you got seven old white guys holding up an animal? No, nothing else is going on there.
I mean, that is horrible.
In tuxedos? No.
Seven old fat white guys holding up an animal. I mean, that's a terrified, mortified animal.
Stick on a tree stump. Stump back mouth.
That is horrible.
With the top hat.
They should take those people, along with the executives from Exxon, and beat them to death with Ken Lay and Jeffrey Skilling.
All right, let's move on. There you go. So what? What happened?
He saw his shadow.
So it's not going to be summer.
Was scared.
Tomorrow?
And ran back into his hole. And, yes, six more weeks of winter.
Well, it's going to run back in the hole every time. There's like 50,000
shove them in there.
50,000 drunks scaring the shit out of the animal.
What is the yellow thing? Do they put them in a bag or something? Gobbler's Knob. Couldn't be a more appropriate name for this fucking place.
That's where they're going to film the next cowboy movie.
Gobbler's Knob Mountain.
Here we go. Thank you, Derek. Jesus, we need this today.
Going to go down and see the groundhog today?
Phil Connors.
I sure as heck fire remember you.
Ned Ryerson.
All right. Really is a good movie, though.
That's a great movie.
Yeah, that's one that you kind of put on if you're switching around the channels and it's even halfway through. You kind of just stop.
You have to keep watching. All right, so we got Bug Guy here. Where were we? The honeybees.
He pulled the German cockroach out. It saw its shadow, which means six more weeks of Nazism.
And we have wax worms.
Yeah.
Wax worms.
Normal, just...
Yeah, you brought a lot of tame insects, I gotta tell you.
Yeah, these are pretty tame. These are, if you look at these are real maggots, regular housefly maggots.
Yeah.
They'll eat bodies and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah?
Which is always good for, you know, a guinea from Jersey.
Wow. No. I've never seen maggots before.
All right. Well, she doesn't seem to like the maggots.
Very nice. Okay. All right. Well, we got to thank you for bringing the bees in and getting stung doing it. Look at his right hand. It's
all swollen.
You were taking Benadryl all night long?
Yeah. Yeah, but it doesn't do what it does for most people, you know. They're...
Right.
You need the epi shot, right?
Yeah.
Why'd you get stung?
They didn't like being taken out of the hive at night.
Oh, are they sleeping?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got one of those hives.
Pissed off bees.
Yes.
And you woke them and they were like all biting you?
They bit me all over.
Oh, they were pissed off. But we got a whole container. There's got to be, what, 30, 40 in there?
Yeah, and I brought some backups just in case.
So what will you do with these when you're done with them?
I don't know if I'm going to even want to touch them after they've been, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
Probably just open up the container near the hive and see what happens.
Yeah. Whatever, they call them faggot bees after that. And
see if they come back.
Boy, but those honeybees are nothing compared to the wasps I saw in that video last night.
Did you watch that open?
I didn't see it.
Oh, that was a good one.
God, it is unbelievable. These killer wasps.
The hornets, Japanese hornets.
The hornets, yeah. There were 30 of them that took out 30,000 honeybees, took out a whole colony. 30 of these huge wasps come flying in. One of them comes in, marks it. Like, he goes out on a little scouting mission. Marks the hive.
This is a video that shows the whole process?
I said the clip of the Japanese hornets I told you about.
Yeah, the Japanese hornets, and it's filmed very well. I mean, they get these up-close views of everything. They get inside of the nooks and crannies in the hive and everything. And the hornet flies back to his crew and goes, hey, I found some honeybees. I marked it with some pheromone or whatever the hell they call it.
Yeah.
And then they take off, and they get to the honeybee hive, and just with these huge jaws, start biting these bees in half. They were just, and you're watching bee heads falling and bodies just kind of shaking around. They went through the entire colony in what?
Three hours.
Yeah. It took 30 of these wasps to kill 30,000 honeybees.
And they couldn't gang up on the wasps? Were they trying?
They were trying. A couple, they killed like a couple of them with the stingers that they have, but they're just no match. But then at the end, they showed this honeybee colony that has a system. The wasp comes in. Yeah. There's a hornet comes in to the tracking hornet, the initial just one. And as he's laying down his pheromones, the honeybees gather around him and start shaking. And from their shaking, they work up so much friction that it gets up to 120 degrees. And the bees can take 120 degrees. The hornet can't.
How the hell do they figure that out?
They cook the hornet alive, and he never gets to go back and tell his crew where they are.
And they just figure this out.
Yeah.
You gotta love nature.
Yeah. They did this little weird abdominal shift thing. The hornet flies in. All these honeybees are sitting there kind of moving. And then all of a sudden, every one of them goes, quarter turn to the left. And that told all of them to jump on this hornet and start shaking. Like, where does that come from?
It's the way you feel as a white guy when you walk into a black club. You just feel like everybody is doing some kind of a signal, and they're going to attack you at any second. You walk into the wrong bar, and you feel like everybody's just kind of like looking at you and signaling each other.
That is crazy.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to get to you and your honeybees in a little while, bro. Thank you so much for helping out the show.
Thank you.
We just didn't think we were going to pull off the old bee trick today.
No.
Are those holes too small? Too big, I mean.
But no, they're covered up with some kind of
some kind of breathing
membrane. Okay. I wouldn't even touch that though, because I'd be afraid one of them would poke their stinger up through that.
Yeah, I had
gauze.
Them in a plastic bag originally, and they were stinging me even through the plastic
bag. Yeah, he just got stung like crazy. Now where's the contraption? Let's bring the contraption in again.
Are we going with the contraption?
Yeah, because intern Bill modified the thing.
Oh, intern Bill did.
Yeah, bring intern Bill in.
Is it true that you tried to collect intern Bill as a new insect?
Here's Bill. Here's the phallic apparatus that the boys will be using today.
Got two of them.
And we just learned that someone's going to have to blow into the tube to get the honeybees riled up.
Riled up because they don't like human breath.
Bill, are you willing to blow into the tube?
No.
Blow into it?
Sure. Yeah. While it's attached to the guy,
the guy's got to put his sack in there. And then you have to blow it. Well, you don't have to get more than a foot away from his bag because you got to blow in the front of that tube.
You got to blow into the front of the phallic tube, yeah.
There's got to be better ways than that.
How about if he, maybe he could just blow on his balls and then put the thing on real fast after?
Oh, so yeah.
Just trying to be helpful.
Now, how did you modify it?
Well, instead of just using whatever we originally had, I put gloves, latex gloves, and stretch them out across the hole which the balls are going to go in.
And so the balls will fit through comfortably?
Yes. Comfortably enough that the bees won't get out.
And the bees won't be able to get out?
No. As long as they don't rip them out while the bee's stinging them and pulls them out.
Yeah.
Within moderation, this should work very well.
With basic odds, what are the odds?
We got to remove some of that tape around that so we can watch the bees.
Yeah, we got to be able to watch it. So cut it away, maybe.
Maybe cut it away slightly.
I'm trying to razor it off.
We got to be able to see that.
The backs, I'm trying to keep open as the windows.
Well, also, we see the back of his balls. Yeah, that's wonderful.
See, but the problem is, this is the only part you're not going to be able to see because this is going to be up against their body.
His taint.
Yeah.
Yeah, we need to clear that open.
I think they're going to do it like this.
Well, they might be able to do it.
That, or you could do it sideways, because they're just dropping it in, right?
It can really go any way.
I guess you're
doesn't
right.
have to stick out like a big penis.
I would just make more room so we could see from other angles, I guess.
Odds-wise, what are the odds, as you're loading the bees in here, that some bees will escape into the studio?
He's not an expert at this. We're fucked.
I've never done this.
This is close to 100 bees the more I look at this container.
Yeah.
We need to get just a few in these tubes. I don't know how we're going to transfer.
How would you load bees into that?
I think we're going to get a plastic tube. And we're going to try to transfer them that way. This way they'll go through the tube into that thing, then we'll close it off.
Sure they will.
The neat thing is going to be that when honeybees sting, they die afterward because they lose their stinger.
Yeah.
So their stinger will actually be stuck in their balls, and then it'll just keep pumping away, secreting that poison.
Is that what it does?
Yeah, and then, so if you don't let them pull that stinger out, it'll just make everything just a little worse.
Oh, God.
Well, wasps can sting multiple times, so
right. Yeah.
Are they going to go after the bees in these things?
We have wasps?
Yeah, some guy showed me a wasp at some point.
Where? We have more bees out there?
I don't know. I don't know where he went. He just had a wasp in a Gerber jar.
Bring him in.
Well, who has wasps?
Who's this guy?
I don't know. He's got some goodies, too, though.
Hey, bro, what's up, man?
How's it going?
Get on that mic there. You brought a wasp in?
I got a bunch of wasps.
How'd you get these?
We work for the phone company.
Yeah.
They sting the shit out of us all the time.
I bet.
Holy crap.
Got two singles and two jars with four.
How'd you get them?
Mike dug them out of a pedestal yesterday.
Oh, these are yellow jackets, no?
No, they're paper wasps.
Oh, okay.
That wasp is nasty.
And then if we heat this up, those guys will be dancing around like your bee sound effects.
Oh, God. Is that a whole nest in there?
Yeah, pretty much.
Holy crap.
Wait, what do? You, when you're up on the pole, you're going to grab something and they just fucking attack you?
You pop a terminal open and right in your face. And you look like a lunatic waving your hard hat in the air. I got the spray with me that we kill them with just in case.
Why don't you spray it before you open it?
Sometimes we do. If you see an opening, you squirt in the sides. But
you see them kind of swarming around before you.
How many times have you gotten stung on the job?
I got it about over half a dozen. Most notable being on the flat part of my ear.
Right. I used to get that with attic jobs when we do jobs in the attic. And I would just leave. I'd be like, hey, there's bees here. I'm not doing the job. Fuck it.
Hey,
they're all like clustered on. Oh, that is just so goddamn frightening.
With these, all you got to do is open a jar and press it against his nuts and rattle it up a little bit. All we got, if we heat that up, like last night when we were in the office breaking them up, they were crawling and very active. But overnight,
pissed off.
It's cool
it gets
now.
A little colder and
right.
Oh, I got the heebie-jeebies officially.
Okay. Yeah, that little nest there. Who is this? The Ooper?
Ooper.
The Ooper. What's up?
Hey, I love the show, guys. Just wanted to say, when you get one of your boys to blow on the tube, make sure it's not E-Rock or it's Bad Bets. It'll kill the bees. Well,
joke was made earlier, sir.
All right.
You hear him all nervous? You went Bad Beth?
Yeah, I didn't say it right.
I've noticed on Pal Talk, the girls showing up a lot earlier today on the Pal Talk cams. Anytime guys' testicles are going to be... exposed here on the program, the ladies figure it's their day.
Well, who's going to be the expert here?
On balls or bees?
On bees.
I'll determine if someone's stung. My method is very simple. If they scream and drop a jar, we have to check.
Well, how are we going to get these bees into the contraption?
Well, they're pretty slow right now. I could probably wrangle a couple in there.
Can we do this outside?
Yeah, this will be done outside of the studio.
No, I mean outside.
Oh, you mean outside?
It'd
outside?
It'd be better because they'd stay cold. Yeah. As long as they're cold, they're going to move around like that. Look, let me bring them in and heat them up.
Don't drop those.
And they're going to get nuts.
I got no problem. Callously?
Yes.
Carelessly?
No, callous.
Yeah?
Wouldn't
callously be if he was, like, throwing them around and spitting on them? And
yes, that was kind of why I was saying that the way he was handling them to me was callous.
All right.
Also, with wasps, I believe your creepy bee guy could confirm this, but they don't lose their stinger like bees. They're
no.
just going to keep jabbing
They'll
and jabbing
keep going
and
at
jabbing.
It. Yeah.
Until
they're a tough guy.
And these guys aren't allergic to bees? The Super Bowl guys?
They say.
How did
willing
you get that
to
nest?
Sign.
You just dug it out?
Well, yeah.
Just knocked it right out of the terminal into a jar.
Actually, into a water bottle. He squeezed
really?
All that through the neck of a water bottle, and last night I cut the water bottle open and started to break them up into individual jars.
Whoa. Ballsy move.
They were
ballsy
sleeping?
Move, my friend.
Yeah. So, all right, game on. We have plenty of bees. We have wasps. We have something that looks like yellow jackets, but they're not. You're saying they're paper
wasps?
I
looked up yesterday to let Steve know exactly what they were.
Okay.
Paper wasps.
I have no problem with them loading that outside. Yeah. Just so there's a complete barrier between us here in the studio and loose bees.
Well, there's a lot of bees. That's the problem. I can understand if we try to transfer one or two and it gets loose, whatever. But there's, like, I mean, that jar is close to 100.
No, I don't even want one bee loose in here.
And this is,
turn it over.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, my God. Look how many are
bottom.
On the bottom.
Yeah, kid.
There's got to be close to 100 in this jar as well. And then individual wasps.
You know, mixing them together might really get them angry.
Yeah.
Oh, what, like different camps?
Yeah, like a couple
You mix the wasps and the honeybees and stuff. All big race war. Some kind of conglomerated, a lot of mongrel class of bee.
The balls will be the battlefield.
Yeah, that's for sure.
That's great.
And this is just the grand finale.
Yeah.
Finale, excuse me. The ultimate challenge.
It's the ultimate challenge. This is like a decathlon of the nutsack.
We're just waiting for the beekeeper suits. They're coming at 8 o'clock.
I want a beekeeper suit.
All right.
I'm going to have to put a beekeeper suit on.
Let's bring the EMT guys in.
Yeah.
I want to
see some of the dangers involved.
You guys can hang out. Just go to the back wall for a little bit. We don't have many mics, that's why.
Here they are.
Here are the EMT guys. They're outside the studio almost every morning to say hi to us.
Our
and now
buddies.
We finally need them.
Our buddies, anytime we need them, they are here to help out.
Never a dull moment with you boys, I gotta say.
No, and they have been there for all the fun things. They were there at the Hard Rock. Remember the Hard Rock when someone suggested, what was the really bad suggestion that we knocked down?
Somebody wanted to swallow a knife.
Yeah, a guy wanted to swallow a knife.
Oh, yeah. For St. Paddy's Day.
And we were dead set against that. And these guys kind of confirmed that that was a real stupid thing to do. So we just had a guy piss his pants, which is harmless, good harmless fun. We had a drunk come up on stage and piss his pants in front of hundreds of people.
What else have you guys been involved with us?
God, Jesus.
55-gallon drum challenge.
That's right.
I believe.
Were you the ones that dragged the one girl out on a stretcher?
Yeah, the one that got the cockroach in her ear.
Nice. She got a cockroach in her ear,
that's
and
right.
they couldn't get it out with their equipment there, so she had to be brought to the hospital. Mm. Now, the fun part of that was it wasn't just a cockroach in her ear. She had been in the bottle, a drum for quite a while.
Yeah.
And we had been dumping cow blood on her and all kinds of disgusting stuff. So as these guys are taking her down in the stretcher, she's covered
man.
In blood. It looked like she had been just stabbed hundreds of times.
The building
People
was horrified.
People were horrified. Horrified.
Yeah.
But they took her down there and pulled
know,
it out of
New
her
New York
ear.
Being the wonderful city, nobody just... No, it's... The stalking look.
Got a gawk.
The maniacal look of madmen.
If there were camera phones back then, would have been a lot of pictures.
So the beekeeper's suits or whatever are coming. The one guy has some spray that could calm the bees down if he gets too crazy.
No, it
kills them.
Kills them on contact?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Zyklon B just seems to calm them down.
Yeah. Good one.
And these guys are telling us they're not allergic, but let's say they have an allergic reaction. That's why you guys are here.
Yeah. Airway will close up. They'll swell up, itching.
whole lot of fun stuff.
The airway closes up.
Closes up. An allergic reaction, the airway closes up, and that's why we're all concerned.
And
By the way, any of you boys allergic?
I don't know.
I don't know. That's what I meant to ask.
Intestines. How about you guys?
Does this, do you build up an allergy over time, or if you're not allergic at 8, will you maybe be allergic in your 40s?
No straight answer to that. It could change
it
almost
overnight. It could just change. You don't know.
Do you have stuff with you?
Yeah.
What do you got? Show us what you got.
Oh, shit. Got some epi.
Show us the tools of the trade.
Yeah, got the epi.
You got the pen thing?
Ambulance. The cardiac monitor. We got not the pen thing. We go direct for the IV drugs.
I was given a pen thing because I had a really bad allergic reaction to, I guess it turned out to be chickpeas or hummus or something.
I was in the emergency room.
And
you were stung by a chickpea? The hell does that even happen?
And then I went to an allergist and they wanted to give me one of these pens that you stab yourself with.
Wow.
You have to stab yourself with it violently.
Yeah, it's
a harpoon.
Oh,
my God.
It's like a harpoon.
Dude, they got the paddles.
Yeah, you got the paddles?
Cardiac monitor.
Nice.
The whole nine
yards. Can you fire those babies up or what?
Hey, that's the finale.
That's the finale.
You
right
guys have
balls.
To take the paddles to the balls.
What would happen? If he's looking for a new job.
Only before
hold on,
you do
hold
it.
On, hold on. What would happen if you took the paddles to the balls?
Not good, dude.
Not good?
Not good at all.
But
I can't even joke about that.
I hear if you do it, you do have to put the paddles and yell queer instead of the normal clear. It's kind of gay.
You know, I hear that people that pay big money for that, too.
Yeah.
All right.
Wow.
Dropping in the tubes for the airway, manage their airway if we need be.
All right.
Uh-huh. And yes, all the technical individuals out there, there is a medic in the room before you start getting all the phone calls.
Yeah. So. It's not just some guy that bought this stuff on eBay. And
right. Canal
I think
Street,
I know
man.
How to use Canal this. Yeah. Wow, great.
Oxygen tank behind me and a full drug kit. So,
all right.
I start whipping out the needles, you know.
And any ambulance. Puppies full of heroin?
Later. Talk to me later.
Love that story.
Yeah, we'll get to that story after the break. And a bambulance downstairs.
A bambulance.
Just in case we need a bambulance.
Got a bambulance.
Just shits and grins.
The little voice in our head wants to say something.
Voice in your head. Don't do it. Don't do it. Remember St. Pat's.
Not like we're gonna have this done in a church. What do you mean?
To wasp ass fucking in St. Pat's.
For your career.
Well,
every
it's
once in a while you gotta take
career.
That chance. Every once in a while you gotta take the chance.
Don't do it, boys.
Today
don't
we roll the dice. Today
Super
we
Bowl.
Roll the dice.
Yeah, it's Super Bowl.
Dude, if something goes wrong, the company will always stand behind you.
Every once in a while you gotta just put it all on red.
Right.
That's what we do.
Spin the wheel.
Mike the Trucker. What's up, Mike?
Good morning, man.
Hey.
Hey, I just wanted to tell you, this show is just going to have to be an epic production. I already have my jaw on the steering wheel shaking my head already at 7 o'clock this morning.
Well, yep. I didn't expect this many bees because we were having a real problem finding bees, and now we have too many.
It's going to get utterly fucking chaotic in that studio.
Yeah, I think so.
I love it. Later.
All right, thank you. Let's go to Dana the Trucker. Dana.
Hey, how you doing?
All right.
You guys got girls coming in. Why not get the girls to blow through the tube for you?
Dana. We have girls coming in today?
We do.
Why are we listening to Dana?
Are you scheduling our guests?
No, I thought you guys said you guys had girls coming in today.
No.
It's just
another sausage factory.
Oh, man, that sucks.
All I see is guys everywhere we look.
No, we don't want girls
But it's safer that way, trust me. Women wreck radio shows unless they're getting naked.
2 years later, she'd be in court saying, they held my head to the tube and made me blow. I was degraded. Shut up.
How disorganized are we, though? A caller suggests something, and we're like, really? All right. It must be so.
Good. Maybe girls are coming in, all right.
Maybe we just forgot. I don't know.
Bring them right in.
All right, Dana, thanks.
Thanks.
All right, so I think we're all set. And the guys are here, the contestants, the competitors.
Everyone's here. How does that? Wow.
That never
I'm
happens.
Stunned.
They're here? Stunned the guys?
Iraq?
Wow, Iraq.
Hawk?
Iraq's got a look on his face.
How about you turn on the wireless mic you're holding first?
Yeah, what
of
are
all.
You trying to do?
Before you look around clueless,
Iraq
maybe
has
you
this,
should turn on the mic.
Iraq has a clueless, surprised look on his face that I can only describe as Iraq.
Thanks.
So come on, Puxatony Eric.
I'm in here. I didn't see if the contestants come in here yet. I'm trying to find out for
you. How do you find out? By looking around the room.
Yeah, how?
Checking in the other studio. Maybe they saw the contestants come in. I don't
know. You think
know.
They're going to help you with a nod? They're going to let you swing and not know what you're talking
they're
about?
They're going to let you just sweat.
Hang you out to dry.
You should
dry.
Know that by now. Steve.
Let's Iraq.
prognosticator of prognosticators has determined nothing.
Blah. Huh?
Jesus.
Steve, we got the contestants here?
I saw two. I think they were all contestants. I don't know.
Can you tell when Steve puts his headphones on,
Ben,
people?
Yeah.
We'll get everyone out for
right when he starts talking.
Yeah.
We got two of the guys here?
I think if one of the guys might have brought a couple extra people with him, but there are people filling out paperwork, yes.
Yeah, they're going to be filling out paperwork for the next hour and a half.
Yeah, they absolutely will.
Because just when people come in here to do dumb things, you got to fill out a packet.
Oh, yeah.
I can only imagine what they're filling out today.
Extensive. Dude. Extensive paperwork.
Yeah. Are you scared of these things, Steve?
Wasps? Yeah. Not really. I mean, I've been stung by a bunch of them before. It's not fun, but...
You want to just stick your hand in real fast?
Absolutely not.
Why is
not?
It true your grandfather visited Cuba in 1956?
Yeah, I don't see what that has to do with my ball bag going in a bee jar, but...
Right, well...
Are you or were you ever a member of the Communist Party, sir? Have to ask these questions, gentlemen.
That is very funny. Let's say hi to Joe in Brooklyn. Joe!
What's going on, boys?
Hey.
Hi, Joe.
All right, two things. First thing is those wasps that the Verizon guys got there. I work for Verizon, and wasps are no fucking joke. We've all been stung by them once you go up on a pole. Secondly, Ron and Fez have got to be fucking panicking because you guys know that Ronnie says, quote, these guys have no sense of fucking history. Every time you guys do a bit, they panic because they think they're going to walk in and have no job.
It is a pretty crazy way to run your life.
I know. I don't like doing this either any more than Opie doesn't. It's our job, though.
It's our job to lay it all on the line every once in a while. What can I tell you?
It's nice being back, you know, at the base every so often, but sometimes you got to go out on patrol.
Yep. Yep.
And you just go into that great unknown.
It just makes this show so special.
Right.
The chances we take.
And sometimes when you go on patrol, you leave without your weapon, just making the Arabic woman noise.
I know.
Alone.
I know. Listen, we are pretty stupid. Let's go to Big Mike. Big Mike.
Yeah, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey, you're going to have the other contestant blow into the tube for the other guy when he's got his ball bag in there.
That ain't bad.
Because that way, there's the. It's like playing defense on football. You know, you got the... You anger them more. If you got, like, Jimmy or Ben doing it, then it's, you know, you don't know if it's the same.
Yeah, the other guy's going to do it with some gusto.
Yeah. The harder you blow,
the
angrier the bee's going to get.
What a great idea. We'll have them 69 each other.
Right.
That's another ball bag challenge, too.
Oh, fantastic.
That is
great. Thanks, guys.
I hope everyone saw the contraption on opianathlete.com. It's ridiculously phallic. Yeah. And now we learn that someone has to blow into the tube to get the bees excited. Let's go to Bruce in Louisiana. Bruce.
Yeah, hey, guys, I'm not sure. The news may be getting a little bit premature, but 2020's running a promo that says they've got exclusive footage of just days before the last live broadcast of Opie and Anthony.
Are they already running that?
Yeah, how did that 2020 thing go, Jimmy?
It was very good.
Yeah?
I sit on West Broadway, and a lot of people won't talk to you. I wrote out a questionnaire so I could even get them to stop. And most people just keep walking, man, but I wound up getting enough people.
Well, the gimmick was for you to walk around, ask people questions, but using foul language, cursing during the question.
And I didn't curse at them because that's not an honest
response.
Right,
it's not like, hey, fuckface.
Yeah, because anyone gets mad at
them. How do you feel about the war? It's, I don't think they're getting enough fucking support. You know, what do you think?
I'd say, how do you feel about the war? And they would start to talk. One of the questions was, do you think President Bush, Danny came up with these, do you think Bush overstepped his boundaries when he was authorizing the wiretaps? And some people were like, yes. I'm like, you know, I agree. A lot of people have said that that's really fucked up. And also, how do you feel about it? And then go right to the next question. Make it very casual profanity and just see how they reacted to making it conversational like that.
Now, Danny wrote some of the questions?
Those are the questions he came up with. 2020 didn't know what they wanted to do.
Now, wait a minute. Does Danny now get a credit at the end crawl on 2020?
Yeah.
And Than?
Yeah, I cleared Than that up immediately. Too. Oh, no, I mentioned Than might be involved, and they said, fantastic guy? I'm like, yeah, they're like, it's handled.
Will it be Than-tastic, whatever the fuck your last name is?
No, it's great. Than's going to add that to his resume and say that he's a writer,
for 2020. Yep.
Written for 2020.
Why not? For John Stossel.
Right.
Everyone punches up their resume.
Why not? And when does that air?
Friday night, I think. I actually forgot I did it.
Tomorrow night?
Mentioned it. Yeah, I think so.
Oh, that's kind of
cool. I should find out.
Maybe you should. Let's tape that for Monday's program.
Yep.
Let's say hi to RJ in North Carolina. RJ!
Hey,
How's it going, guys?
Hey.
I've never gotten through before. I just wanted to get through and say I enjoyed this show. Good luck in your future, and glad I got to get through on the last day.
All right. Thanks, RJ. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm a little nervous today.
Just a little.
I'm getting that feeling that I get just every once in a while.
You know what I love, though?
Have you had it twice already?
I've had the feeling only twice. Yes.
I love the fact.
No, actually, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, Anthony. I'm just going to. Actually, I've had that feeling since coming to XM a lot, which is ridiculous considering our history.
Yeah.
Like, you would think coming into this new gig, we would never get that feeling again. I could think of three times already that I've had this exact feeling I have today.
But it's been cleared. This has all been cleared, Opie. And when it's been cleared, nothing can happen.
You're a stupid man.
It's not like Sex for Sam was something that had been done times before.
You're a stupid, stupid man.
It's not like everyone knew about it. Oh, they did. It's not like it had sponsors. Oh, it did. This has been cleared by everybody. Everyone's signing release forms.
This sounds way too familiar.
Oh, God. I'm buying a house.
The only reason they accepted this is because I'm sure they sold that shit out of it.
Oh.
Or maybe they didn't have the heart to tell you guys that they're just not interested anymore. And this is their way of doing it. Like, yeah, go ahead, do the contest.
You know, I thought that exact thing last night when I was going to bed. I'm like, what if they're playing us? What if they don't want to pay out our contracts? What if they really want to get rid of us, but they don't have the heart to do it face-to-face in an office? So, like, they found out we're doing this and just said, yeah, let them do this.
Well, you know what? I don't think they're doing that. And it's like I always say. I mean, my friends at Sirius, I mean, that's a great company. And Mel and those guys are probably,
You know, Howard, a pioneer in satellite radio and the collection of people he's bringing aboard. Great, great talents.
Second to none.
Second to none. And to tell you the truth, I would be honored to go over there and work for Sirius.
Would you call Howard your boss?
He would be. Why wouldn't I?
I would actually walk in and go, morning, boss.
Morning, boss.
No names.
Right.
Sellouts. Let's go to Jeremy in Jersey. Jeremy.
Hello.
Hey.
Listen, Harvey Keitel said, you're going to be okay. You're
going to
be okay.
Yeah, we need that clip today to make ourselves feel better. Ladies and gentlemen, live from Washington, D.C., it's ELO.
I don't know what the most repulsive thing was actually hearing the word Howard and my boss come out of all three of your mouths at the same time.
I did not say Howard and boss.
Here's the other thing. I have never in my life seen more like preparation. I saw an email yesterday that said, okay, video the contestants signing the release, burn me two copies of the DVDs and FedEx to them. That was an actual email that was exchanged yesterday.
Wow. And they're videotaping them filling out the paperwork?
They're videoed. I mean, I don't know what else you can do.
Yeah.
I'm just here calling, assuring you, I have your back.
Thank you.
You know something? You sound just like another great hero. During our career days.
Don't say it.
Ken Stevens.
Our friend Ken Stevens. Did we tell you what Ken is doing now? He's on a sailboat somewhere.
In the Chesapeake Bay.
He's sailing somewhere in the Chesapeake Bay.
When you go to lunch today, why don't you wave to Ken? He's out there somewhere.
I heard he talks to a volleyball that he has a handprint of blood on.
The guy hasn't shaved in 3 years. He's hanging out with mermaids and a volleyball.
Yeah.
It's all part of my plan to get on my
Ken
boat.
Ken Stevens.
Good old Ken Stevens. Oh. We got to call him live on the show one day.
Yeah, I want to talk to Ken.
Our old boss.
We liked Ken very much.
Yes. All right. I just wanted to dispel the what we call the jock paranoia.
Yeah, we have that, but you can't blame us.
I remember those moments as well with this show going on, 19 months or whatever the hell it's been now?
Yeah.
What, our show?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I can think
we're
of
into
few,
our 17th month.
Moments when my phone rang, I'm like, uh-oh, here we are again.
Yeah, of course.
See, I'm from the school of thought that some of the more tamer things that we didn't prepare for were more dangerous than the bigger things that we do prepare for. Like the tamer thing, so what? Perhaps there was a little drinking going on. Maybe a few liberties were taken with some of the females at the party.
We don't know.
Perhaps.
There's no video.
Dude, do you think there's video? Do you really think that if somebody was drunk in this studio, I would have taken them into where Ron and Fez's studio is right now and fucked them?
Never.
Without a condom? Do you really think I would have done that?
Never.
All right, I'm
hanging up. Bye, Mr. Logan.
Bye,
this is too close to home. All right, Elo. Elo, thanks for the support, I guess.
We love Elo. Look at him. He's right there with us.
And he will be at the end. Yeah. I don't know. They won't call me back either.
That's how it all begins.
Oh.
Let's go to Peter in New Jersey. Peter!
Hey, boys.
Hey.
Hey, I was on Audible.com, and I see they're taking pre-orders for the final show.
Actually, Audible.com has... what's the big sell on the Audible.com? They got like 10 best of discs they're now selling.
Ooh.
On Audible.com.
Wow, there you go.
Something like that.
That's a great way to spread the virus to people that don't have XM yet. You download it, you give it to them, you go, hey, here's what I'm listening to. And then they go, holy shit, need this.
For a price, I think it's like $5.95 a disc or something. There's 10 of them. I don't know.
Then you say, yeah, well, it would be good, but they don't work there anymore.
Yeah, but Audible.com now has best of Opie and Anthony CDs.
Can you put them on your iPod? Is that how you download them for your iPod?
Yeah, download them right to the damn iPod. So
can we go on iTunes?
I think what it is, it's all those bits we were playing.
But you'd rather go to Audible.com.
Are they competitive?
You inept idiot.
Are they competitive things?
I don't know.
Any downloading service would be.
Well, it's like saying the CD is being sold in Best Buy as well as this and that. They sell them in all the stores.
Is Coke a competitor of Pepsi?
Yeah.
Yeah, but
Audible is the best.
Are they? Okay. Well, look, dude, I was saying that iTunes is a bunch of faggots. I mean, I just didn't want to get anybody mad.
There you go.
What do I know?
So go to audible.com, see what it's all about. But I think it's the CDs from the best of shows we did at the end of the year. The best bits since coming to XM. I think that's what's up there now. So you can download and spread the virus that way. No? It isn't that?
No.
I thought that's what we agreed on. Why is everyone shaking their head? Talk to E-Rock. He put it together.
Uh-oh.
I thought we were going to do the end-of-year discs.
We haven't done those yet. These discs were made before we did those shows.
But Don told me it was going to be the CDs from the end of the year.
We have 10 discs up on Audible.
Right.
They're all some of the best stuff from Opie and Anthony coming to XM, but it's not the exact shows that we had. I bring nothing to the table.
Are we going
to
add those other things?
Yes.
Those other CDs eventually?
I bring nothing to the table.
Well, there's 10 best of CDs on Audible.com. You check it out for yourself. If you like the titles, then download it. If you don't, whatever. All right? All right. Should we take our first break?
I'm scared.
Yeah.
We'll talk to the contestants next.
Jimmy overslept today.
Yes.
A little bit.
7:04, Ben rang my phone.
Were you out a little late?
No, I actually was in bed probably earlier last night than I have been all week, and I set my alarm. So I don't know if it just didn't go off or if I just hit it when I woke up and then went back to bed.
I was a little late this morning.
What?
A little late, 15 minutes late. Some tractor-trailer full of gravel decided it was time to turn completely sideways and tip over on the expressway, blocking all of the lanes. He could not have positioned that truck. A stunt driver could not have positioned the truck better to block every single lane of the expressway.
It was amazing video today.
And spill gravel all over the place.
And sand, right? It looked like it was more sand than gravel.
It was just a big, like, multiple bulldozer buckets full of shit from somewhere. And at that hour, this tractor-trailer drivers, everybody on the road is just a maniac. So that tipped over. All of a sudden, I come around a corner, and all I see are taillights. And I'm special. I know this. I'm just special. I know everybody on that road with me has to be to work, but I have to be here on a radio show.
Right.
Which, for some reason, makes me more special than everybody else. So I had to get around everybody. The driving I did, I was listening to the traffic report saying the LIA is completely closed. The service roads are all blocked up. The Grand Central is now packing with traffic.
It was the top story in the news, by the way, because I was in here watching the video, watching where you were stuck. It was unbelievable.
I'm like,
he's not going to make it.
I got behind it and was screwed. I was stuck in the traffic. I could have been worse. I could have been next to the tractor-trailer, but I was stuck in the traffic. No exit, nothing. You can't do anything. My traffic report... clear sailing on the shoulder of the road, and even clearer sailing, people, if you take the hill of grass that goes up from the expressway to the service road, That's about at a 45-degree angle. Try driving an Escalade. I felt like, what was that, the old Joey Chitwood stunt team that drove on two wheels? I was completely tipped over on the grass.
Oh, you did like the Men in Black move.
Where they go right on the side of the tunnel.
On the side of the tunnel.
Where no one was driving. No one could pull in. You know, I saw people trying to drive on the shoulder, and then other people try to use the on-ramp to get past people and then zip right back in. And some guys will dart out to keep them from doing that. No one was even trying to block me because I no one drives there. And 15 minutes late, I guarantee there are still people sitting there in traffic that could not get past.
They couldn't even fathom doing that
move. No. It is such a ridiculous move to make that no one else... I looked in my rear view thinking, all right, I'm going to start a trend here.
Yeah.
Nothing. Not one other car would do this.
Yeah.
And then you get the idiots at the service road. Once you make it to the expressway service road, there's small side streets that come out onto that service road. During the middle of the day, I guess you need lights there because traffic's pulling in. Not at 5 in the morning during a big breakdown on the expressway. So you blow those lights. There are people stopped at them. So now you got to go around them and look at them with a look like, why are you stopped at this light? Why? Just go. It's not like a cop's going to pull you over. He's at the friggin' carnage on the expressway. So I made it in 15 minutes. Huge wreck. 15 minutes.
You know what I suggested today, and I hope you take it to heart. The pal talk thing that's exploding as far as this show goes.
Mm-hmm.
You got to do the old pal talk commute in every day. People will check you out driving into work.
I just got to bring the laptop with me and put the cam there.
Why don't we try to do that next week?
I will definitely
as an experiment, see if it works.
Give that a whirl.
I think that'd be hilarious because one guy on pal talk does that.
Yep.
He just has his webcam out the window as he's driving around.
Yeah, you need some kind of Verizon wireless to do it live. I'll figure it out. I'll look it up.
At the worst, you could just tape it.
Yeah, could tape it, then play it back. I'll work on it.
All right.
We'll get that done.
Because I think people would be very impressed with the moves you pull.
Oh, I was impressed. And I'm not even impressed with my stupid moves anymore.
No.
Got me here, though.
But it's because you're special.
I am special. I had to be in.
All right. Let's go. We're getting ready for Super Bowl on the Opie and Anthony program on XM Satellite Radio. People are starting to pile into the Pal Talk rooms.
Yes.
The contestants are here filling out lots and lots of paperwork. They're getting videotaped, making all sorts of statements on video.
Is there any betting going on?
What kind of betting can we do?
I don't know.
We'll get the contestants in here in a little while, but they're definitely going through all the paperwork.
I bet that I can sleep late tomorrow without being late for work.
What was the other thing I was going to say? Steve Kim comes in here. You know Steve. And E-Rock goes, Steve, what's wrong? He goes, oh, this is so stressful. Half the stuff that these guys brought in, we'll never make it into the studio. We have to say no right off the bat.
Really?
So we should get Steve in here. Steve is shrugging. What, was it was bad to mention this?
Grr.
Maybe Steve is just sick of coming in here and getting abused.
I think Steve is just disgusted.
Steve, what's wrong?
No.
I saw you kind of rolling your eyes
as I said that
in the other studio.
Grr. Whatever. Yeah, some of the stuff they brought in, you know, will not make it on the air.
Like what?
Like what?
Vice grips.
Well, yeah, vice grips are a little much.
Yeah.
I don't think you're going to be able to... do anything with vice grips.
Yeah, no, anything. Well, one guy was going to bring one of those industrial, like, C-clamp kind of vices.
Yeah.
He was going to bring that. That got nuked last night. What else got nuked last night? Rat trap.
Your ball sack off.
Someone sent in a few rat traps in a cardboard box this morning. We looked at them, and they almost took my finger off when I was, like, setting.
Do you have them here?
Yeah, bring in the rat trap.
Bring in one. At least one.
All right.
Maybe bring in two. I want to see a rat trap.
Bring in the stuff you said no to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just lay it on the table.
This is kind of like the video you get to see when they do at the airport.
Yeah,
and stuff, and they show you the boxes of stuff they got off.
Here's
people.
What we have confiscated right. So far.
I want to see the stuff they're saying no to.
I want this contest to be safe. I think that they should let in cotton balls
and maybe some sugar, perhaps an apple.
Things that tickle.
Yeah.
So that the one that giggles the most,
loses.
He loses.
Ah.
So.
Oh, wow.
These two lovely devices are rat traps.
Let me see that.
Here you go.
Wow, those look like, looks like someone built the better one.
Somebody was going to take this to their nutsack?
Well, they wanted to.
Get the fuck out of
here. You know what that is? It's a miniature bear trap.
Yeah.
Dude,
that is a bear trap.
All right, let me try.
Put something in there.
Yeah, give me something that...
Oh,
yeah, no thanks.
Look at this.
Dude.
Watch this.
See it. No, it's going to flip
is
up
it on Pal
something.
Talk?
Oh, my God.
Look at this. Is it on Pal Talk? It's like a bear trap.
Whoa! You know, dangerous, yes, but I'm intrigued by these things.
Here.
No.
What are you? It's not going to attack you on its own.
It can!
Let's play Toss the Rat Trap.
Let's not.
I don't want to play Toss the Rat Trap.
Kind of like, you know, the old egg toss game. Let's play with a rat trap.
Let's not and say we did.
Hey, Jim?
No. Don't toss.
Oh, my
wow.
God. The whole trap jumps up.
That's frightening.
Yeah.
Can you take a finger to that, you think?
No!
No, no.
Why not?
No,
wait a minute.
You might be able to take a finger to it.
It's just like a big...
It really hurts just...
Yeah.
Just snap. Ow! Okay. Shit. It's called T-Rex.
It's a black... It looks like a black mouth with teeth on it.
That the trap's called T-Rex?
That was at barely half volume on my hand, and it really hurt.
You see that? Does it look like a mouth? I feel like I'm trying to sneak a muffin past Patrice.
Oh, he got it.
Oh, those things rock.
Yeah, I kind of like these.
Someone has to take a body part in there just to try it out.
I can't load mine now.
Let me see.
Oh, yes, you can.
Oh.
Okay. It's supposed to
snap. You broke it already?
Uh-oh.
I don't know.
Ow.
Doesn't it hurt?
It hurts a lot.
It doesn't. Oh, good. You broke it.
That one's busted. Oh, there it is.
Okay.
Hope you load it. Guys, put your hand in there.
Don't do it. Do it at 11.
We have EMTs here, though. Holy shit. No, you're crazy.
No, don't.
You're crazy.
Break your hand.
Why?
Don't.
It will break your hand.
Yeah, that's designed to snap a rat.
Dude, I'm doing this right here.
Yeah.
That just being closed like that really fucking hurts.
Yeah.
I closed it around like my knuckle. Ah!
Look what it did to the pen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It broke it.
Oh wow! That
yeah, you just cracked
balls.
Your pen.
All right, so they can't use this on their
absolutely.
On their scrotum.
Oh God! Imagine your scrot in that.
Nope, no rat trap.
There's no way to to disarm it without popping it. There's no way to disarm it. No,
right.
Stop throwing them.
Well, maybe if you give it your eyes. So disarming. Disarm it, Jim.
Let me just give it these baby blues.
Blink, blink.
And by the way, I got to say, we got to talk about Rich Voss at one point today because I heard he did everything.
Oh, my God.
We got the audio.
Yeah, okay. I listened.
We got to get him on the phone or could he stop by even? Is he in the area? Maybe we could get Voss to stop by.
Did the miscarriage.
He did the miscarriage joke on commercial radio.
And the laughter that comes out of those guys' mouths to try to cover up for just a horrific story is worth the price of admission.
Oh, really? All right. Well,
which is free. Because it's, what they call free.
We'll check that out a little later. John,
I have the sniffles.
I see that.
Stay away from me. I just got over the flu.
I won't give
it
right back.
Took three fucking weeks to get
the flu. Hopefully it doesn't go to full-blown sniffles.
No, I don't have FBS.
John in Virginia. John?
Hey, boys. What's going on?
Hey.
I just want to let you know, before I let you know what my plans are for today, I'm calling from Lynchburg, fucking Virginia, home of Jerry fucking Falwell. And there's WOW stickers already in this conservative.
Oh, cool.
Good.
Love it. Hey, listen, here's my plan. I got up an hour early just to listen to the Super Bowl. Told my wife I got to go to work early. Called my boss. Called in sick. I'm sitting in my minivan. Got a six-pack. I'm ready to roll.
All right. Yeah, Jesus. We got to get the...
Make a day of it. They're tailgating, Opie.
They're tailgating.
For Super Bowl.
Well, it is Super Bowl.
Punch out.
All right. Are the guys done with their paperwork?
Almost.
Almost?
We have to get videotaped statements from them.
And the vice grips.
Oh, yeah, the vice grips.
Those weren't going to
pass
either.
Vice grips.
I'm amazed we're doing this today, by the way. We've been trying for 5 years to do the old beast thing to the ball bag.
This started at WNEW. We were told we had a great prize, an Aztec.
Yeah, maybe we shouldn't mention the prize because these guys are kind of doing it for free today.
No, but I'm mentioning the prize because we never got it.
Right.
It wasn't that stupid, what's his name? Our promotion guy, Roger, Roger, I am going to get you guys two Aztecs to give away. It's like, oh, great. Okay, that sounds good. And then we came up with the bee sting thing, and they said no. And then they told us we didn't have the Aztec. It was a bunch of bullshit. So we gave away an actual Aztec Indian, who I hope is still with that family.
Just standing there in front of the cigar store.
Drunk in the gutter on 57th Street.
Ah, juicy fruit. All right, we get it. Just keep mopping.
Just keep mopping. All right. As the guys fill out the rest of their paperwork and do their video statements so they don't sue anyone. Oh, Voss is on the phone now? Where?
Where is that little angel?
Hi.
I just got a note that Voss is on the phone. I don't see him on the phone, though.
Uh-oh.
All right, you know what we could do?
Eric's indicating that Derek fucked up.
Derek, you fuck up? No. Derek doesn't fuck up. I didn't believe that for a moment.
Well, Hawk was kind of indicating it.
Were you indicating it?
No. Okay. No. No. He's so serious, man.
I know he is. It's like a peak frame.
Will you smile?
It's a very serious cookie.
That's right.
This is not a real job. Will you start smiling?
Exactly. He doesn't, though.
We goof off on a daily basis.
We smack each other in the head in here on a daily basis. All of us
but
take
for some
shit
reason,
from each
he's
other.
He's the one that can't
the
take
The second
it.
You give it to E-Rock, he's like, no. Or he'll give you that face like, pfft.
Here's the problem. Like poor Eric. E-Rock. Eric has tried to figure out every angle to just be comfortable and enjoy life.
Yeah.
And every time he has one that just makes him okay, he's hurt for it. And I gotta say, Eric sometimes wants to smile sitting next to Ope. Ope's like, why don't you smile? Eric will smile. Dude, you gotta be fucking paying attention. Stop smiling. Stop smiling. But I was only trying to smile.
I've gotten better. Stop.
Wipe that look off your face.
Poor Hawk.
All right. What we can do here, the drunk audio bit is starting to take off. Our new bit, thanks to Craig Ferguson.
Yes.
We're not going to take credit for this one. Craig Ferguson came up with this on his late night TV show. Basically, what he did was he took George Bush, slowed down the audio, and George Bush sounded very, very drunk.
Yeah.
Very drunk. So we've been doing this off and on for the last few days. Now the listeners are taking some of the audio they like from the program, slowing it down so we sound drunk.
Mm-hmm.
And we got some examples here today.
All right.
The one with Norton yesterday was really, really funny.
That was some chemistry. That was uncomfortable, actually. Like, that. God damn it, that is exactly what I sound like drunk.
Yeah.
You want to hear another one?
Certainly.
All right, Mike sent this in today. Listen to this. Opie and Anthony in this one, sounding drunk. Let's go to Fuzzy Numpkin. Fuzzy Numpkin, what's up?
Yo, what's up, boys?
Hey.
What's up, little Jimmy? Hey. My cousin lives in Italy.
Yeah.
And he sends me this fucking email, and it's like, it says drunk idiots on it. And I open it up, and it's your fucking ball in a mousetrap video. All the way, so just wanted you to know.
From Italy.
Is spanning the globe.
Titled as drunk idiots?
Yeah. Not even close, but whatever. At least
it's out there, you know.
That's what's great. About the show, it is a virus, and now we're using some of these crazy video clips that happen in the studio, and it's your job to pass them along to people that don't listen to the program.
You know what it used to take to get your material on an international level like that? And now, right after it happens, people all over the globe, the world, get to watch the hijinks and shenanigans. Yeah. Some guy in Russia, boom, there he is. Guy getting his balls snapped in a mousetrap. There's someone in Italy I would just get a report of. All the time you hear in Australia, New Zealand. There's people listening and watching what we're doing in here.
Quebec. Yeah.
It's amazing. Crazy. Quebec, thanks, Canada. You know what's great about it? As you slow it down, what you say becomes more asinine. It's like it's all over the world, man.
And then you name cities in the world.
Yeah.
Italy.
Quebec. Like that's important to what Anthony just
fucking
said.
Sri Lanka, man.
Oh. And any direction reversal you do when you're talking, like, you know, I'm going to go down there Wednesday.
Yeah,
it becomes,
No, Wednesday.
I just got a note handed to me. I'm sorry. That's not Opie and Anthony slowed down. That's actual audio from our WNEW days.
Ah, right. Okay. That must have been about 3:15.
Right. So
Ron should be standing there calling you. I know, buddy. I know, buddy.
I know, buddy. Hey, you never cut me any slack.
We're heard all over the world, Ronnie.
I know, buddy. I know, buddy.
I fell.
Ron and Fez are kicking so much ass on the program. All right, here's Coke Logic. He sent this in. And this is the one I thought people should do. It was when Jimmy and I were fighting.
Yes.
A real fight that happened for like 45 straight minutes.
Did you know it was that long, by the way, when it happened? I had no idea.
I thought it was 5 minutes.
Absolutely.
I thought it was a 5-minute stupid fight before he got back into the show. It was 45-plus minutes. Coke Logic took some of that audio from this real fight that Jimmy and I had live on the air and slowed it down to make us both sound drunk.
What is rude about forgetting to say goodbye to a guy when there's
nothing.
Dude, when there's so much shit going on.
What was going on?
Chris Jericho was here. I think we had something that we had to do at the show, you know. Make sure the show ends on time and in a nice fashion.
That's a lot of shit going on.
I don't know, dickhead, because I don't know what was going on that day, fuckface.
Aw, don't get all angry and yell. You can't say you want me to voice my opinion and then get so pissed off when I voice my opinion.
You're insane.
I'm not insane.
You are insane. You're insane at times.
No, I'm not.
So Sean Ross didn't get the proper goodbye. Oh, well, it happens.
Okay.
It happens.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
You can sit here and try to figure it out.
See?
You can!
All right. Wow. It's not as good as the first one, but it's still good.
It sounds a little bit digitized, or whatever, like a little bit echoey.
Yeah.
Like for that.
Because it's
like,
hard to slow down.
He sounds drunker than I do. I don't know why you sound drunker than I do, because maybe it's the way the audio is playing.
I think it's you talk so fast.
Yeah, you talk fast,
argument.
So by the time
it
you
almost
slow
sounds
down.
Normal.
Yeah. Well, the next one came in from Chris P. There's just a few more here. Chris P., bitter, drunk, gay Howard.
And this is going to sound weird to say, but I felt bad for Opie and Anthony. I mean, I honestly felt their desperation. They blew their career. Before they actually got big, they... You know, that's probably, they would have had a big career, but they really screwed up big time. They're desperate guys. I mean, they're so desperate to be famous. So they showed they had like 10 or 20 fans show up with signs. Yeah, they had some signs and stuff, and everyone just kind of looked at each other and said, this is so sad. They kind of want to tie in with us in a weird way. It was kind of weird. And XM, similarly, like buying some ads during private parts, like I know they think that like irks someone or it's going to maybe like, wow, we really got them. There's a huge movie about my life on VH1. It looks desperate.
There you go.
That really sounds good.
We got to be smart and cut them off because that goes on for another like 4 minutes.
Wow.
We don't want to wreck this bit. Let's go to Steve in South Dakota. Steve.
Oh, man, you guys are fucking killing me here. I'm driving down the road, and I just spit Mountain Dew up all over the dash of my car when that first drunk audio came on.
So you got to be careful. What they do is they find certain audio that is misinterpreted. Like, I am not drunk. I am tired, and I've been driving.
Yes, sir.
Not that anyone would slow that down.
No. No,
you guys are
good.
I'm just looking at him in the crib. Can't I just look at him in the crib and tickle him? I thought that was his neck. That's his crotch. I didn't mean it.
Look, I may have had a few.
No, don't make it easy for these guys.
That is true, and we're talking drunk. Yeah. There's nothing worse than playing drunk, and we're both doing it like two fucking Dudley Moore idiots.
Hey. You could go fuck yourself.
Oh, yeah? Well, take that cock out. I'll laugh at it.
All right, let's do the next one
here.
You
never loved me, man.
All right.
I don't fucking love you like a brother, Ann. You never loved me.
Jimmy, don't wreck the bit. We could get 2 to 3 weeks out of this
shit. I tried.
That means we don't have to work as hard. All right. It's much better if they just take the regular audio and slow it down and make us sound drunk.
You just don't know how to return.
No,
love.
Don't wreck the bit.
Wait, let me just.
You just don't know how to return. Love.
Sweetheart, were you skinnier at the bar? Did you get fatter in the car on the way home?
All right. Here's Duke Bluk in Tennessee. He slowed Jimmy and I down.
I love you, man.
Here we go.
All right. Tomorrow's the big day. Super Bowl.
Yes.
It's going down. It'll still be worth listening to. There's going to be a lot of things going on with these guys going back and forth, making fun, Jesus. Abusing their balls. Their ball sack. And then the ultimate challenge is the bees. And we're having a really tough time finding bees for the ultimate challenge tomorrow.
I find that hard to believe.
I really do, too, but I guess they're sleeping. The bees are sleeping, and we can't wake them.
People have to know where they are, where you can dig them up and get a couple.
I say we're not trying hard.
We don't need 10,000 bees. We need a few bees.
Just a few.
I need someone with a little bee knowledge. Knows where to get them.
There has to be a lab that has wasps in it.
Yeah.
A lab.
A lab?
All right, we're bailing on that one?
Yeah.
We didn't have time to listen to these beforehand. That one was okay. A lot of people suggesting that you got to get Stalker Patty drunk, Big A, Twitchell's. We're just at the beginning of this bit. I think this is going to have some legs.
Yeah.
Finally, the last one for today. Nicole sent this in. It's Jimmy and I fighting.
Ooh.
You slow it down, and we might sound drunk here. We don't even know because we didn't listen to this ahead of time.
Jimmy just fucking set me off in bullshit.
Yeah, well, you annoyed me too, so I guess we're human.
Now it's bullshit, bro.
Say what you want to say, but I'm not some idiot. You're annoyed at me, I'm annoyed at you. It's life.
Basically, he thinks we blew off Sean Rouse last week.
Because no, you.
I didn't blow off Sean Rouse!
What happened?
Huh?
What happened?
Yoshi's here and the dude from Slap Happy. And Jimmy's like a little up to, are we going to get him on the air? I'm like, yeah, eventually we'll get him on the air. I'm not like, whoa, let's stop the show and get these guys in immediately.
That's all she said in.
Yeah.
She was onto something.
I like that because I sound very rational. And you're very drunk and belligerent. I'm like, all right, whatever.
I'm just, what's going on here? What's all this then?
That would be hard to do. Too bad you can't slow one down and leave the other fast.
Yeah.
Well, the one guy did that.
Drunk.
Oh, really?
The first one with Anthony, where they featured Anthony, the phone call was in normal speed.
Yeah.
So it sounded like we were just drunk talking to a caller. Mm. Well, this has some legs. We'll pre-listen next time so we play just the best ones. But there's a good sample of what came in over there.
Sure.
Okay. Let's say hi to John in Boston. John, what's going on?
Hey, is it just me or does Opie sound like Frankie Blue when you slow down the
Frankie
video?
Blue.
Good old Frankie Blue.
Frankie All right. Blue.
Thank you, sir. Let's go to Mike on Long Island. Mike, what's up?
Hey, O&A, guys. I just wanted to thank you guys for playing the Super Bowl for a Thursday. That way we don't have to wait out the whole weekend to see if you're still on the air.
Yeah.
Right. We do these things on Thursday now.
Later, right. Boys.
All right. Thank you,
Although
sir.
Although we usually are on the air the day after.
Yeah. And then all
then we have a weekend.
Over the weekend.
And then, then there's a problem.
All right. Let's say hi to Nick in Utah. Nick, what's up?
Hey, I just wanted to suggest that someone needs to take the Emily Stern audio and make her sound drunk. I think that would be really funny.
Oh, man, we already have the Emily Stern bit that's just taking off just when we thought the bit was dead. Thanks, Nick.
My tits are godly.
The Emily Stern remixes continue to come in. We got
27 that came in overnight.
Holy shit.
We're not going to play all 27. We've gone through half, and we've found three or four so far we like.
Mm-hmm.
We can play a couple real fast here. You want to hear this
one? Sure.
Listen to this. See, we like when they're quick.
That is a good one.
That was Anthony B. with his Emily Stern remix. We didn't know where to go with this bit, and we finally felt our way around this one.
Yeah.
And you finally figured it out.
Sort it out, and the listeners come up with ideas. Some of them stink, but this one's a good idea.
This is Daryl T.
Damn, that's an ugly vagina. Damn, that's an ugly vagina. Quite concerned, like semen must have turned. Damn,
that's a good one.
This one is probably my favorite that came in overnight.
They're coming to take
my ass.
Ha-ha, they're coming to take
my breast.
Oh, hee-hee, ha-ha.
To the Kabbalah Center.
Where life is beautiful all the time, and I'll be happy to see those nice young... They're clean white coats, and they're coming to take
my vagina.
There you go. That was from Rev. And
very good, Rev.
I think we have time to do one more. Finger Younger sent this in.
Finger Younger. Bastard. Even when you know where they're going, still funny.
Of course. There you go. What do you rock? Ben?
The B-suits are here.
The B-suits are here?
Yes.
Ooh.
How many? Let the Super Bowl begin.
Cool. Yeah, bring beekeeper suits?
Yeah, bring the beekeeper suits in.
Are they heavy? Are they thick and hot?
They're nice.
Are they nice and lightweight?
And where are the contestants? Do they fill out all their paperwork?
Ooh.
Wait, Ben, get on mic. Did you hear that?
What?
As they bring on the
be a little while, they're still filling out the paperwork.
I go, Ben.
Wow.
He goes, they're not even close to finished with the paperwork.
It's going
to
be a little while.
Yeah.
All right. 2 hours.
And trust me, we're not trying to stall to make you listen longer because.
Did you hear what Jimmy just said?
What?
I said, those look silly.
Those look silly. Of course, they're beekeepers' outfits. Jimmy, they're always silly.
Jimmy, put the thing on.
I don't want
it.
I'm going to look dumb.
I was going to call it a hat, but is it a hat? Yeah, I guess it is a hat. All right, I didn't see the hat part. Put that on.
Silly in this.
Put that on for Pal Talk and get a picture for OpieAnthony.com.
I want my beekeeper hat.
Oh, my God.
I don't like wearing a beekeeper hat. I don't like it.
Can I see that one?
I feel like a boy in a cage.
All right, and Anthony has his beekeeper hat.
It's got like,
Hey, Kook, why don't you take your regular hat off first?
Yeah, which way does it go?
Over the head, what do you think?
Yeah, right over the head.
Yeah, netting first.
And Anthony has his beekeeper hat net thing on.
I'm ready. Ugh, you look just like me.
No, I don't.
That is really creepy.
You know what the most frustrating thing is? I feel like we're at the end of a movie and we want to kiss, but our beekeeper masks are preventing us from doing so.
Brokeback beekeepers.
I had to quit you. You look ridiculous.
No, it won't work that way, you goose.
He's trying to put the headphones on.
Let me
try
it under my beekeeper.
There we go.
All right.
All right. I'm rocking now.
Wait.
Hello, caller? Hello? Hello, caller? I can't hear the caller, Opie.
And we got the wasps.
Yes.
We got the wasp hanging out, some bees.
I am so excited.
How's that?
Oh, it works with the headphones.
Yeah, but the hat doesn't go quite over your head.
You just kind of.
Why does the hat have to look so wacky?
It's fucking awful.
Why does the hat have to look wacky?
Dude, I want a Kango beekeeper hat outfit.
All right.
Thank you, by the way.
There you go.
Well, that's better. Now I could hear.
You know who you look like? The guy from Poltergeist 2? God is in his holy temple?
Oh, when he's talking through the screen?
Yeah.
When the old man comes to the screen door?
You're all gonna die!
You're all gonna get stung.
All right. All right, well, just stalling and waiting for
the
guys to fill out their paperwork before we start Super Bowl.
I might just wear this. Like on the way home, driving.
Let's just walk down the street in our beekeeper fucking... You know what you do? Two of us walk down the street in our beekeeper out uniforms and walk anywhere and just stand there and people will think that there's bees all
there's
over.
There's bees.
Miss, I have to check your panties.
Clear the way.
Anyone have a hammer?
What, sir?
Sir. Yes. Beekeeper guy.
Beekeeper suit guy.
Why does Opie get the prettier one?
What is that one?
This is an antique beekeeper.
Oh!
Give that to Opie, the old one. I don't want that.
Yeah, an antique.
Yeah, and you put the whole suit on.
Yeah.
And then you zip the, you zip the veil.
The neckline around the collar of the suit. I see. Now, what else about, like, wrist protection or gloves or...
Well, you should be wearing gloves, and if you didn't bring your gloves, you know, you're pretty much...
fucked.
You're pretty much beat.
I'm going to pull my hands in the sleeves
That's
and
the
rubber band
it.
Them shut.
Yeah, actually, the newer suits, they may have a little elastic on the wrists.
Because I don't want them crawling up my arms or legs.
You definitely
Nobody
don't
does.
Want that.
No one.
You guys look really silly.
Well, yeah, but you know what?
Silly but safe.
You look beyond silly.
Why does anyone have a... There's one... We Anthony and I have little hats.
This is to be... You're supposed to wear this with a hat. You put the hat on.
You bring your own hat?
A regular hat, yeah.
And then that's stupid.
Well, see, they've advanced.
Yeah, because the bee could get in through that hat hole.
Yes.
I don't like that.
Yeah, it's... I don't want that.
Well, we're wearing
you have
like
the right one.
This looks like it's sort of like a park ranger hat, and it's got like screen all the way around it.
Well,
and then this very flexible screen to the bottom of it that zips into the suit.
Yeah, so well, the pictures will be up on opieandanthony.com.
I like this.
Yeah,
someone's got to roll video on this so I could superimpose huge giant bees invading our studio tonight.
Yeah, Japanese hornets.
Yes,
get some Japanese hornets.
Okay, I'm gonna do this. All right, someone roll tape on this. All right, I'm waving them all around, trying to get them off of me. Okay, Oh, that'll look good.
I have to do it in the background, too, because it would look silly if bees were only in your side.
If just me, bees would love you, too, Jimmy.
That's right. We'll look like assholes.
Screw that.
Mm.
How do you drink a beverage in your bee suit?
Yeah, I never thought of that. What if the beekeeper gets thirsty?
Yeah.
You have to plan ahead.
Right? Yeah, you got
to
drink and piss.
Bodily function has to be done beforehand.
Before.
What if you have diarrhea and there's bees all over? What if you have diarrhea and you want to get blown? What do you do?
How are you sure the bees are off of you before you take the suit off?
You should do it with a partner.
Yes. Ah, that's sexy.
Always good
too.
With a partner.
Yeah. That makes it sexy.
What are you doing back there? Checking for bees.
Checking for bees. That's it.
And gathering the honey. Jesus.
Open that up. Let me scoop my hand in there. See if there's no bees on it.
Yeah, because I always, anytime you see a beekeeper working, I see it on like the Discovery Channel, things like that. There's bees all over them, and they don't seem to care.
And even if it petrifies me. Yeah, and even if you know you don't have any bees on you anymore, when you're driving home in the truck, you think you still have bees on you.
Yeah. So, well, thanks for bringing in the bee suits.
Thank you.
You got it. I also brought you some, these are T-Rex.
Oh, that was you?
Oh, that's you. You Jesus. Crazy
yeah,
bastard.
These are rat snaps, but they one-handed. And they would really hurt.
Dude, how do you...
There's also mouth. I'm sorry.
Would that break your finger?
No. No, it didn't.
No, what is that I'm saying?
It could.
It could.
It definitely would break
your
finger.
Sure you get a lot of meat in there. You know,
I want to be brave enough to take one, but I don't know.
Do you break your finger?
Well, I think I would go in with my hand.
That's the way you got to do it.
Side of the meat of your hand.
That you could take.
Let me tell you something. I rested it. I opened it and closed it, like, slowly on my hand, like, on the past the pinky where the bone is.
Yeah.
Just letting it rest there, it left, like, those little teeth indentations in my hand.
Right. Yeah, it's got teeth, like a bear trap.
Well, you know, the teeth, it's so that if the rat or the mouse is not killed immediately, he will be suffocated by the teeth. So, you know, they're thinking.
Yeah.
All right.
Wonderful.
And what's your name?
Ross.
Ross, you want to get a plug-in for the company?
Yeah, it's Eden Environmental, and you can pick up all of this stuff, bee suits, the electric mouse trap that Opie had a lot of success with.
Yes.
You can get that at pestcontrolworld.biz.
Actually, he was the one that gave me the electric mouse traps.
Oh, nice.
And yeah, I'm up to 12 kills, by the
excellent,
way.
Excellent.
Oh, my God, you still got them?
What?
Mice?
No, no.
Oh.
They've been locked and loaded for a few months now with nothing.
Good.
So I got rid of them.
Good.
But beforehand, I was killing like two a day in those damn traps.
Pestcontrolbiz.
Pestcontrolworld.
Pestcontrolworld.biz.
So your business is like pest control, obviously, but
yeah.
But you would wear this bee suit if someone had a bee problem?
Actually, we don't really do bee work, but we like to have the suits handy.
Just
you never
in
know
case.
When... Yeah,
you got a big hornet's nest on the side of the house in the summertime.
Right.
Your kids are trying to go in the pool, and dad's got to dress up like this and go, honey, stay in the house. I'll take care of it and just make a disaster out of the whole thing.
No, the best thing to do is wear your beekeeper suit when your friends don't have them and then start rattling up the bees.
Yes.
Hey, bees, you look like a bunch of faggots, and you swat the nest.
How hysterical would that be to have a big jar of bees,
right.
Go to a park during a picnic, and just release them in your bee suit.
That's right. Or you find the invalid kid in the wheelchair and just throw the bees on him.
And you could stand right there laughing at him because you have the bee suit on.
Do you want to hear a tragic story about a guy who, I think it was a killer bees story. It was a guy pushing his invalid kid, which is, of course, where I got that, in a wheelchair.
Oh, no.
In a wheelchair. And he pushed the kid into a ditch by accident at a park or something.
Accident.
And there was a whole killer bee nest in the ditch.
Oh, no.
And they swarmed up all over the little fella. And the guy tried to beat them off as somebody had to wind up running away. So he leaves his kid in a wheelchair in a ditch being stung to death. Well, he fucking hightails it out of there.
Oh, that is horrible.
But that's not going to be some insurance questions on the claim.
All right, we got the bee suits. Ben, are they done with the paperwork? When are they going to be done with the paperwork? It's time for Super
Bowl. We've got to videotape them signing the paperwork, saying they know what they're doing.
It's
going to
take a while.
Well, actually, we should be done pretty soon. We're moving faster now.
Wait, which one?
Because a lot of people are heading into work, so they're going to have to catch us on the replay, I guess.
I'm scared.
Which one are you wearing, Jimmy?
This one.
Will that, like a jumpsuit type thing? Is it a jumpsuit?
Yeah, it's a one piece.
Will it fit over my clothing?
Absolutely.
So I don't have to get naked in here in the studio again?
Oh, Anthony, stop it.
Sometimes after the show, me and Jim, you know.
But we're not really naked. It's just a couple of hogs coming out for a peek.
Ah, why not, I say.
Don't make it bad.
Ooh.
All right. Let's go to Ricochet.
Ooh.
Ricochet, what's up?
Hey, I want to give Derek props on the pad data, man. He's keeping up with that pretty good. And then I also had a question that would be...
Well, let me just explain. The pad data, we're helping out the people that record the Opie and Anthony show every day. It used to be where you'd have an hour and a half segment and you couldn't, navigate through that. So we're finally changing the pad data so you could navigate around the show much easier. And Derek is having a lot of fun with what he's writing on the pad data, so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's really good. Hey, I got a question to help us out also.
Yeah.
Is there any way, at the beginning when they're playing the music or even at the intro that you could put, intro so you could go past the music instead of having to wait, for all the music to start finish up?
There's actually a reason they can't do that. No, what happens is when you have the pad.
Shut up, Jimmy.
No, I'm trying to help the guy.
Jimmy.
The pad is not right.
No.
Dude, we have no idea.
Pad, it's not right.
Yeah.
Dude, that's what Jimmy says.
No, technically, I talked to Elon about this because somebody else asked about the music.
Uh-huh.
And they said if you cue up the intro music differently, the pad won't be set properly.
Shut up.
I'm trying, can a nigga be helpful and shit? Happy February to you.
Let's get Steven here. I want to get an update. They're confiscating all sorts of torture devices. We're getting ready for Super Bowl. They're videotaping the contestants as they fill out their paperwork. We should be underway very, very soon.
Yeah.
What?
This takes a while. We want to make sure everything... See, in the old days, it would have just been run in the studio,
right.
Do it, big problem.
Got the bees, got the wasp.
Yeah, we'd have been vice grip, sure. Rat trap, yeah, snap
right.
It on your nutsack, asshole.
Right.
And what happened?
What
we would have gotten fired.
All right. Why are you scared?
I don't want to.
Hey, can't they sting through this screen if it, like...
Yeah, that's why they're designed that way.
Your nose like this?
Yeah. No, they can't.
They can't get through there?
You know, guys,
try to keep your head centered.
Yeah. Right.
Don't lean forward.
Yeah, don't put your head, don't sleep on it on the side.
I was going to, take a little nap, but if I lay on a bee, it's over.
Let's...
Wow.
Yeah, let's get Steve and Ben in here. Steve? Well, we just want an update because we're live on the show.
Yeah.
Look at Steve. He's disgusted. The update is they're filling out their paperwork and we're videotaping.
And how much longer, Ben?
A couple minutes.
Really?
Yeah. We just got to make sure that everything that they acknowledge on camera, that they know what they're doing.
It's like a deposition.
Stuff. Yeah, that's very accurate.
25 to 30 minutes. Ah, screw that.
Wow.
I say we let the games begin.
Hey!
Oh, you asshole.
What did you do? You are a fucking maniac.
Dude, what the fuck? Where is it?
I didn't. Oh, man. Oh, jeez.
Zip up, fellas.
Oh, no. Where? I think I saw it fly off. You are an ass.
Why would you do that?
I hope you get cut on that glass now. I think I see him.
We might need the spray to kill him.
Yeah, you think? What else you
do? The games have begun.
Let's open the door and ask him to leave.
I don't know where it is, but it's somewhere loose in the studio.
Right.
Your face was priceless.
I don't like bees.
I hate them.
Well, I broke one of the jars that contained a few of them.
Where? Oh, God.
Dude, right, please.
Give me the suit.
You see him anywhere? Do you see him?
No. No, I don't.
You're right. I think.
No.
Jesus, his hair's all disheveled.
Did you see that?
Oh, what a mess.
Under.
Well, you need to clean up the jar. I'm shaking because they're in here somewhere now.
Where's my bee suit?
Now they're quickly putting on their bee suits.
Jesus.
I don't like the fact that... Dude, how do you cover your ankle? My ankle's exposed.
No, it's pinched at the bottom. You're all right.
It's not pinched that good.
Pull it down over the top of your shoe.
No, it'll bite me.
No. Pull it down over the top of your shoe. I'm a professional.
Holy... Anthony.
Yeah. No!
Right.
Right
there. All right, we should take a break.
Fair.
The games have begun.
I get my bee suit on.
The games have begun.
You ass.
Might as well add another one to the...
No, hold no! No, wait till I get the bee
Don't do
suit
that.
On.
Wait.
There's already a couple in here. We might as well add the wasp
they
to the
can't
mix.
Sing through this stuff?
No.
Why?
When we come back, it'll be
the
a teaser.
The singer is teen.
It'll be a teaser. Look at you. You're fucking freaked out. All right, can I get like something to wipe up the glass?
Yeah.
Super Bowl has begun. We'll continue in just a moment.
Dolphin zipping me up.
Getting ready for Super Bowl on the Opie and Anthony program.
Opie.
I just got an update from Ben. He goes, you... Talk to Rich Voss for a little while, and then you guys are ready to start Super Bowl.
Yeah.
I go, well, what the hell's going on? He's like, the guys need their blood pressure taken.
Yeah, they're taking all their vital stats.
And then I also walked back into the office or what have you from taking a leak, and I hear Steve on the phone with Washington going, yeah, he brought, what did he say? He brought hair removal, what's the strips when you get a waxing?
Oh, yeah.
And then I heard, yeah, those are okay. Okay, they're okay. All right. They're having a conversation with all the stuff that these guys brought in to see if it's yes or no.
What they could use in this competition. I need to be zipped, by the way.
Yeah, Hawk will take care of it. He did me.
Hawk.
I got to say, though, my beekeeper suit makes me feel fat.
Does it?
I look fat in my beekeeper
suit.
Fat.
I heard beekeeper suit.
You don't
suit
care that it makes you look gay, too?
Does it?
Oh, my God.
All right, Hawk.
This is what they should be wearing in Chelsea when they're banging each other. Protective suits. No.
I am safe.
You guys look
Hope
stupid.
So. Look at E-Rod.
I know, and stupid is eating a... You're eating a sweet Pop-Tart.
Yeah,
that won't
Pop-Tart.
Attract any insects.
They're going to lunge for your mouth.
Yeah. Mm. Why don't you just have fucking...
I got a glass in my fingertips. Jesus.
Why don't you have the juice... I can't...
Oh,
the
boy.
Juice.
Oh, boy.
Oh, wow.
But Opie, I slipped.
It could have been good.
All good coming back there, E-Rock. Yeah.
Oh, you get the Harvey Keitel one.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go to Rich Voss.
It's stuck, the zipper? Oh, no, no, no.
Mine's not stuck. I'm all zipped
in. I have to
in.
Be okay.
I'm okay. I'm all zipped in.
You're going to be okay, Andrew.
I want to be zipped.
You're going to be okay.
Hawk,
you're
going to
be okay.
If you have broken my beekeeping suit.
Fix it, Eric. What are you doing? You act like you never zipped up a fucking
it's a zipper.
A paranoid man in a bee outfit before.
It might be stuck. Rub some mayo on it.
This is foreshadowing of how Anthony's going to look soon doing the radio show on a regular
absolutely.
Basis. No, are you kidding?
Yeah, only it's not going to be screen.
It's going to be bubbles.
Plastic bubble, plastic oxygen. Bubble.
Yeah. That.
I hope a wasp lands on my face just so I can panic in my... Here's what I would do. If a bee lands on me, I'm going to panic and rip off my bee suit and run. I'm a faggot and I hate bees.
Boss,
bees
what's up?
Bees are scary.
Hi, Rich.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, bro.
Hey, you know, when you were talking about the quadriplegic that fell in the hole and got stung, that was one time he didn't care that he was a... Oh, go ahead. What were you going to call
it? Oh, wow.
Well, the words were too big.
I knew you were in trouble when you first said quadriplegic.
Quadriplegic.
I can't get close to the mic because of this.
I know. You keep bouncing off the
thank
mic.
Thank you, E-Rock.
Well, were you guys happy with the performance yesterday?
I didn't hear it, but I read about it on the message boards.
Well, we got to do the old setup, the old radio setup, because people don't listen to the show for 4 hours every day.
Right.
Well, they're crazy. All right, go
ahead. Dude, I broke a jar all over my stuff, so now I can't even... Oh, here you are. Okay. So yesterday, Boss was on our show, and we found out that he was doing commercial radio right after us.
Yep.
A show called JV and Elvis.
Well, you found out I said I was doing it. I came right out and said I was doing it. Okay.
Somebody yeah. ratted you out.
No, they didn't, because nobody knew I was doing it. But
yes, they did. A listener called up and said that Voss yep. is going to be on a show on K-Rock.
That's after I... Are you guys really that crazy? In a day you forget? I go, when I leave here, I got to go... Well, go ahead. Keep going.
Doesn't matter, Rich, how we found out.
Yeah, what's the
really,
difference?
Rich?
Doesn't yeah. really...
You Jew rich. Motherfucker, you ever correct me again and I'll kill you.
All right, go ahead.
That's pretty brave coming from a guy in a bee suit.
I know.
From a protected guy?
Yeah.
A smart gentleman?
That's right. You're there with fucking... I can't wait till they attack your fingertips. The bees are going to sting the sweet crumbs on your fingertips.
There you got glass in the
how
fingertips.
How scared are you that it's going to crawl up where the headphone cord comes out of the zipper?
We have our zippers open, the zippers open probably a millionth of an inch. Like, it's wrapped around the headphone cord.
Yeah.
I know that the wasps are going to find this cord.
There's going to be one Luke Skywalker wasp that's going to know exactly what the weakness in our Death Star suits are.
He'll fly in.
Stay on
around,
target. Yeah.
Get you to take your mask off, and the other ones will attack and sting my neck and ears.
You guys look so...
I don't want to get stung, Opie.
I don't either. I'm a little worried about the mitts.
Hey, Norton, with your zipper open, do you feel like you're in the meatpacking district?
That was funny, Rich.
What a jerk. No, I don't.
It was very funny. All right, so you went on JV and Elvis' show here in New York. They're on a station called Free FM.
Yes.
It's free, even though they play 20 minutes of commercials every hour. And how we set this up?
They're really bad radio. I don't know. They're kind of like old school hacky kind of radio.
Do we have to play all these
bad radio
talks?
Voices and stuff? And Rich was going to be on there.
We so found out because a listener ratted them out, right?
Yeah, a listener called up and said Rich was going to be on. So,
oh, God.
So we, you know, had asked him to do a couple of things over there. We had a suggestion of a funny anecdote of a woman on a bus. And he went on and did it.
Yeah, there's no joke here. We just told Voss, why don't you set up like you have a really good joke and
yeah.
then do it.
And blindside him with something horrific.
And see what their reaction would be. And their reaction was to laugh just uncontrollably?
Yeah, like it was a really funny joke, but you could tell they were just uncomfortable because it's not a funny joke.
Right.
It's not funny. It's nothing they would ever have on their show kind
right.
of joke.
Right.
But they laughed just to cover it up. And apparently there was a little controversy before Rich even got in there.
Well, yeah, they said, you know, we're sitting in a green room, and they go, we got some calls that Rich was on another radio show, and he's going to come in here and sabotage us.
All right, now, who are the motherfuckers that are listening to this program and then ratting us out to them?
Probably their friends.
Oh, okay. I never thought of it that way.
Probably the producer of their show.
Yeah, I never thought
of
it that way.
We know that pretty much everyone in commercial radio has satellite radio.
Is an intern laughing at me in my V-suit?
I hope not. Everyone's laughing. For his sake.
Everyone's laughing behind your back.
Yeah.
He's the only one brave enough to laugh to your face.
They're laughing at you, man.
At least I know a bee will not be stinging me behind my back.
I hope a bee lands in your jacket pocket and stings you and you put your hands in it later. I'm having my coat brought to the office.
Oh, yes. Hey, laughing boy.
Yeah.
Could you come here a minute?
Yeah. Hey, chuckle boy, get in here.
Don't look at
be
me.
Be a good intern. And please hang this on the back of my chair in the bee-free office environment.
Hang mine first and hang Anthony's over mine in case a bee flies in.
No, hang mine on the back of my chair.
Hang mine under that.
And lose that fucking Red Sox hat.
The preparation for this bit is just downright ridiculous.
That's
great.
He's snotting in the bee suit.
Oh, that's great. You couldn't cover your mouth.
Yeah, he couldn't cover his mouth.
Oh, look at all the crap on your screen now. Yeah, that won't attract the bees. Little snack for them right on the screen.
Can the bee get AIDS?
All right, so here's Voss on JV and Elvis doing the pregnant woman on the bus joke we told him to do. It's no joke. It's just a dumb setup with a shocking punchline.
Shock.
Let me tell you, on a lighter note, I got to tell you a story about, I'm on the bus, right? Okay, so I'm taking, I guess it's up 8th Avenue.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Oh, this is a great story.
You like this story?
This is a really good story.
It better be.
I'm on the bus, right, and we're sitting there. And there's this pregnant lady. She's like 6 months pregnant, 6 or 7 months, right?
He's really good at judging pregnancy, by the way.
Yeah, about 6 months.
If he says 6 or 7 months, it's right in there.
She's like third week.
And she grabs the, we're sitting there, and she grabs the handle up top, and she miscarries.
What the
hell? Yep.
Really?
Right there.
So funny. That is a 10.
Definitely. Me and her were in stitches because, you know, you see,
we were laughing so hard I could barely dial 911.
Oh, did you help with cleanup at all or anything?
Oh, God, no. We're not janitors.
They didn't know how to take that.
How do you handle that story? And boss, 6 or 7 months pregnant, and she miscarries? That's a child being born on a bus.
I think she was 10 months pregnant.
Yeah, something like that.
What an idiot.
And you know what? Yeah. I'm hearing Bonnie. I didn't know. I'm like, who the fuck is this woman interrupting him? I didn't know it was her.
I told her to throw shit into it to make it look like it's a real story, you know, so they wouldn't think. Because before we went in, they go, if these guys sabotage us, you know, there's going to be a problem. You know, and I walk right to the studio, and they go, oh, you're not on yet. And I'm going, they kicked me out before I was even on the air.
Like, what problem were they going to cause for you? Like, there's going to be a problem. Will the problem be?
I don't know, but I mentioned everybody's name. I did that, and I started, you know, they go, well, you're an abrasive comic. What makes you that way? And I go, I grew up in a tough black neighborhood, and, you know, there was a bully, this guy Patrice O'Neill, that used to just, you know.
Yeah, you kept mentioning Patrice's name as the bully.
I mentioned him, Bobby Kelly. O'Neill got more plugs on that show than any other show.
Why, Rich, why didn't you mention me?
I did mention you.
But I'm performing in Albany.
I did. I said, you know, they were talking about who your favorite comic.
Boring.
Well, you know, I'm just... You know what? What do you want me? How do you want me to talk about the show? Oh, do you want me to talk about what the studio looked like?
Boring.
What the fuck went on? You guys call me, you jackasses. All right?
And not boring.
Another thing, jerk-offs.
You
I went in there.
Dick!
Are you guys listening?
Yes, I'm listening.
I go in there.
Boo!
Can I tell you another part of the story?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
By the way, you know, when you're telling these little stories, here's a good idea. Have a point. It makes it so much more interesting for the listener.
That's great.
All right. Can we start talking to the contestants, please?
Yeah, come on.
This show has just been
enough of the videotape testimony.
Yeah, we get it. I'm trying to drink coffee with my bee suit on.
How are you doing that?
I'm in a bit of a quandary.
Can you drink it through the bee suit?
No, you can't.
I'm going to try.
Yeah, you can. I'm sure that net is nice and clean.
Yeah, guy's hands have been all over it.
Filtering it. I'm not that crazy.
All right.
Yet.
Can we get the guys in here? The paperwork from Washington is just fucking up our show today.
This is how I want to hold it.
This shouldn't take an hour and a half.
to prepare for a stupid bit that's going to take 10 minutes. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen.
Sociopath number one.
All right, and your name is?
Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Oh, this is the last minute guy from yesterday. You're not allergic to bees, right?
No, I am not.
What did they make you fill out?
Just release the liability. I hold you guys responsible for nothing. It's all on my own.
All on your own.
All on your own.
And they got you on tape saying that too, right?
Yes, they do.
This is the same thing as if you just did it at home on your own in your basement.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
And
Ben's laughing. You laugh when the bee stings you.
Why are you laughing, Ben?
Jim just looks funny in his outfit.
You think?
Drinking his Starbucks.
Beekeeper's outfit. Of course it looks ridiculous.
It's always good when there's a stretcher, you know, outside the studio.
I know. It's just, we've taken all the precautions that we should. Now, the bees are not in the contraptions yet, are they?
Yeah, how are we going to get them in the contraptions?
Bill? The bees are not currently in the contraptions. This is how it's going to work.
Yeah.
There's a safety gate between the actual unit that the balls are going in and the tube.
Yeah.
You put the bees in with the gate on, and you close the tube at the end, and then they're going to put it on their balls, and when they're ready, they're going to open the gate, and the bees will come into the container.
With their nuts.
Yes.
Because each one of you will have to blow into the tube to force the bee into the nutsack region of the other man.
There's still we have to figure out how we're going to get that.
Yeah, oh, Bill,
we need
come
a blower.
On.
We need a blower. All right. And that's the ultimate challenge, by the way.
Hi, Steve.
Look at this cocky guy. Hey,
this is Raphael,
man.
Right?
Sure.
I can tell.
Yeah.
This is Raphael from Connecticut,
representing
Anthony.
Representing the CT.
Yes.
Raphael from Connecticut, started this whole ball bag abuse thing.
Yeah.
He suggested the mousetrap to the nut sack.
Yep.
He couldn't get down here in time, so Matt stole your thunder. And now that video is being downloaded all over the world like crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Raphael was not happy about that, so he challenged Matt to a ball bag abuse.
To a Super Bowl.
Yeah, to a Super Bowl, basically. What did you bring in for your nutsack today?
I brought in I call it the chomper, the little spatula that you pull back and just...
Ooh.
That's kind of interesting. I brought some vice grips, but they said it was too dangerous.
Yeah.
I brought the glue traps in. They shot the glue traps down.
You can't do the glue traps.
They will not let us do the glue traps.
Why?
They shot them down.
I want a reason.
I didn't get a reason.
Let me play devil's advocate because they can rip your ball skin off.
I will not
and
rip
the
your
problem
ball
is,
skin off.
I'm just saying that's probably what they're thinking.
It's just it's sticky stuff. It's like fly paper.
It would just remove hair. I'm thinking.
Yeah.
What else did they say no to?
Steve had brought a
God, we
stapler.
Work for a weird company. It's like you can't use glue traps, but you could
get stung in the balls by bees repeatedly over and over again. That's okay, but I can't put my sack on a fucking
Wait, are
glue
your
trap.
Your balls pretty tough. Are you like when you guys bang chicks? Are you into a girl like twisting your balls and stuff like that?
Occasionally, yeah.
Okay.
Why not?
All right. See so these guys. See,
are you married? Girlfriend? What does she think?
Engaged.
What does she think?
She thinks I'm a fucking lunatic.
Yeah.
But, is that her right there?
But that's okay.
Yeah. All right.
But
so what are you going to do to your nutsack? You're going to do the spatula?
The spatula, the mouse trap. Let's bring all the bees out. I'm ready for the ultimate challenge.
Yeah.
I was thinking about possibly dry shaving my sack. And then if you guys had Icy Hot, we could have played Icy Hot.
Oh!
Another brilliant scheme I thought of along with Steve... representing Connecticut over here.
Steve, you're a Connecticut kid, too?
Yes, I
You
am.
Know each other?
No.
Oh, okay.
Different ends of Connecticut.
Yeah.
My brilliant idea was for us to remove our shoelaces and make one long string and tie it around my hog and his hog and possibly have Jimmy karate chop it. Now, we didn't talk to them out there. I don't know if the lawyers know about
I'll
it or
tell
whatnot.
You why I would do that. Think,
yeah. But that's going to be fun.
Yes, Jimmy?
I'm afraid if I karate chop it, someone's cock helmet will be ripped off. And then I feel like a silly goose.
I think.
Bounces off the floor, ends up in your mouth.
If
no,
they did want to do that,
no.
A shoelace or a string or whatever between the testicles with a line in the middle and have a tug of testicles.
And let's do it.
Where yes, you each yes. then pull. And the first one to pull the other one over the line with your balls wins.
That's let's right. do a tug-o
let's
testicle.
Do it. We got testicles. We gotta let the lawyers know. We got to fill out new paperwork then, maybe. But let's
yeah,
do
let's
it.
Do tug-o testicles.
Tug-o testicles.
Nobody wins.
Hey, wait. Is your fiance here?
She's right outside. Actually,
Can
I wanted
she
her
be
to...
the official blower? Because we need someone to blow into
well,
the
Well, he has
too.
His girl with him, too.
Oh,
so.
Perfect.
All right, perfect.
We got
two
girls
blowers. We'll be blowing.
That works. Boy, that takes the gayness right out of this,
That's
doesn't
right.
it?
That's right.
Yeah, sure.
I was kind of
All right, what else you guys got? The Tuggo testicles we like. Steve, what are you going to do?
They shot down my staple gun. I was going to do the old Steve-O impression, staple my nutsack to my leg, but the lawyer said no.
Why?
God only knows. I thought you guys were on XM. I mean, I thought we could do anything.
Well, they do have
What's wrong with the staple gun to the leg?
I don't know. Mutilation, maybe. It comes under the heading of mutilation. I'm guessing. I don't know.
Oh, they got to let that through.
And they were small staples. I mean, they were only quarter inch, 6 millimeter. Not major.
Ow.
So what are you going to do to your nutsack?
I'm going
to
make a cup of tea. I'm going to teabag a cup of hot water.
Wow. That machine gets really hot, too.
Of course it does.
Yeah.
Jesus.
All right. That's his special trick. Where's the third guy? Where's Matt?
He's almost done.
He's almost done?
He's still doing paper. Wow, the paperwork.
Holy
shit.
This guy's got here almost
Video
an hour
confessions.
Ago.
Yeah.
These guys are fucking fearless, man.
It's unbelievable.
Like, I'm watching them both talk about the things they're going to do to their testicles very casually. And if I was either one of you, I'd be very psyched out by the other, but neither one of you are. You're both like, yeah.
No.
Let's do it.
No.
I'm ready to whip it out right now. Let's get something in here.
Well,
let's start this.
You
fuck
know.
It.
Wow.
All right.
Let me get a mousetrap. Come on.
Usually there's a lot of excitement in the studio, but we
Anthony,
can wait on that.
Rubber bands.
Yeah.
Lovely to the testicles.
What, you're going to snap like that? Oh, he's snapping rubber bands. Like that. All right.
I one time had a dominatrix, and I'm not into ball torture, but she squeezed my balls a little bit, a little tougher than I like it, and for a second I was like, that was kind of hot. So I can understand liking a little bit of pressure, like, to your balls. So
no.
When you're banging, do you want them squeezed?
How twisted, about twisted. Like, I wanted to bring the vice grips, and like, one of the listeners called in earlier this week and mentioned, you know, I go one full rotation.
Slowly
he goes
tighten.
I mean, keep going.
This guy's the real deal, by the way.
Yeah.
I'll do it, man. I'm not here to play games.
I don't know much
voltage.
About Steve, but Raphael, you're definitely the real
Raphael's
deal.
Raphael's got his game balls on. Sure. Definitely. You can tell.
All right. Is Matt ready to come in here? Can we at least talk to him and then
he's getting
continue?
His blood pressure and everything finalized.
Oh,
yeah, he'll come in.
How'd you guys do on your blood pressure?
Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah. Low, high, what?
Normal.
Yeah.
All right. Who said no to this, Steve?
DC
just called and said no to the testicle tug o' war.
Why? Now they're just shooting down anything new.
Now they're getting scared.
Anything new.
Now they're getting scared. We had faith in them down there.
Tug a testicle, Soapy. What an event.
What an event.
Do you think that the lawyers, when they got involved with satellite radio, and they're worried about FCC things, ever thought they'd have to decide, should we let two men tie something to their balls and back up in opposite directions?
You know when you're playing, when you're doing regular tug of war, there's like mud in the middle?
Yeah.
It would have been nice to get a gay guy or something waiting in the middle.
An open asshole in between the
Oh, God.
All right.
No tug of testicle.
No tug of testicle. Who's
such
bummed?
A great
I'm
idea.
Bummed.
I am too.
I think we're all bummed.
XM shot down anything electronic or electrical. That's kind of a bummer also. I mean, electric mouse trap.
Well, the ultimate
car battery. Come on.
Car battery.
Yeah,
Jesus.
Let's go.
The ultimate challenge, though, the bees. Are you guys worried a little about the bees?
Those bees look like little faggots in the jar.
Wow.
Bring them on.
Little faggots in the jar.
He said,
he says.
Bring them on.
Oh, look at this guy. He's got a rope and everything, Matt.
Wow, look at him,
Matt.
Well, he's a tough guy.
Matt's a problem.
Matt is a problem.
He's got the championship belt.
He's got the championship belt on and everything.
How's it going, boys?
What's up, Matt?
Wow.
How's it going?
Matt,
you are dressed for action.
Ready
You're ready to go.
Matt doesn't even have to be here today because he's legendary already. That mousetrap video is being downloaded everywhere now. Everywhere.
It's amazing.
What the hell belt is that?
The Balls of Steel Championship.
It's the Balls of Steel Championship belt he's wearing. Wow, guys, that's got to intimidate you a bit. No, huh?
No?
Nothing?
We'll see.
All right, Matt, what did you bring in?
I brought a lot of stuff in, but didn't get cleared.
Well, what didn't get cleared?
Rat trap.
Yeah, rat trap.
You going to do the rat trap to the balls?
Yeah, I was going to. I brought a vice in. It didn't get cleared.
No vice.
Like, sort of like clothespins, but a lot heavier.
Tighter.
Not clear.
No?
No. Clamps, yeah.
Are they
like
afraid
clamps.
Of crush trauma?
What
the hell?
Bengay got cleared. I got wax. Strips.
Oh, so you're going to wax your nutsack and then slap
like
Bengay on.
Yeah, it's like glue traps, yeah. Glue traps I brought in, they didn't allow that.
All right. But waxing your nutsack, you can do.
That's got to be brutal. That could be a nice
Wow, that okay,
a
that's
nice start
a good
to
one.
The competition.
That's a good one. Waxing the nutsack and
that
then
got
putting
allowed. Yeah.
Ben Gay on it.
Ben Gay, yep. I got Ben Gay also.
Ew, that's got to hurt.
How about, all right, now we got to organize. What we should do is come up with a list of events they have to do. I'm thinking the wax strips first.
Yeah.
They all have to do a wax strip. Yeah. And then immediately apply some Icy Hot.
Yeah.
And then how about what
Ben
else?
Gay was shot down.
What else did you bring in, Matt?
But we're using Ben Producer.
I have a weird question about the Ben Gay.
Yes.
Will that prevent the bees from going on it? Will that freak the bees out?
Wow. Good question. Don't want to sabotage the grand finale.
That might fuck the bees up, dude. They may get sick. Or, it might be like,
I think it's going to make them just go nuts.
Well, they would
and
have
it's only
to go
be
in between rounds and wash their balls.
They, like, the bees may stay away from the sack.
Yeah.
It may be a repellent. It's just something to think of.
Oh, my God. But we need the Icy Hot after they do the wax strips. That would be very uncomfortable. All right. So we start with wax strips. What else did you bring in, Matt?
Ben Gay.
All right. So I'm thinking, help me out, guys.
Also regular mouse traps. I brought about six of those in. You know.
I think they all have to do a mouse trap to the scrotum. Do we start with that?
Yeah, that seems to be. It's
technically,
we've done
somebody
already
did one. I'm not going to mention any names.
So we can do that.
All right, so we're going to start with a mousetrap. They all have to do a mousetrap to the scrotum to start the competition, okay?
Right.
Then I'm thinking wax strips. Is that good?
Yeah.
All right, wax.
Cup of tea.
Huh?
Cup of tea next.
Well, then that'll be the freestyle.
That's the team competition.
Yeah.
And then we get freestyle.
Then we got freestyle, so.
Where you each get to show your individual talents.
I'm thinking mousetrap, wax strips. Ben Gay after the wax strips. If that fucks up the bees, we'll wash them, you know, we'll have them wash up and stuff. And get
I
know, trust me, I stopped myself.
We'll wash your balls.
No, I did not say that. Now they're going to use you saying that.
We have to fight over who washes who.
Yeah,
I write Raphael.
So then it's the Ben Gay, okay? Any other, are we doing piercings or any of that crap today?
I don't think so. All right. No punctures, though.
Okay.
Yeah, no punctures seems to be the rule of the day, except if it's, you know, a bee stinger.
Right, okay, so what else can we do? We got mousetrap, wax strips, Ben Gay.
What about that slap thing and the rubber band?
Well, I think that's his freestyle.
That's his freestyle?
You're going to do the spatula, right?
Yes.
All right, so I guess we do 1, 2, 3, freestyle, and then the ultimate challenge, and I think we're pretty good.
Very good.
Mousetrap on sack only, no nuts. Jesus,
well, we know that.
These notes are coming in like crazy.
We know that.
There's a lot of panicky Pete's.
We've done the mousetrap before. We know.
Do you realize that somebody spent all those years in law school and has to say, should we allow the mousetrap to close on the ball itself? And they're going, no, just the skin. Just the skin and possibly the vein.
I went to school for 12 years. I know that that's as far as we should go.
Wow, 500 people in the talk right now looking for this. Than, if you could slowly, because if you move it quickly, it fucks up. Grab that camera from up there.
500 people?
Yeah, we're going to set up the Pal Talk camera.
We're going to put it in a better position.
We got a two-camera shoot happening in the studio, so we'll have video up online.
Yeah, lots of video.
So are we done? Is there anything else that we're not thinking of? No, then we got to go freestyle. So Raphael, you're doing what's called what?
The Chomper.
The Chomper. All right, he's doing the Chomper. Anthony's setting up the camera.
All right.
Steve, what's your freestyle bit?
I'm making a cup of tea with my nuts.
That's right, Steve.
Cup of tea with nuts?
Cup of tea?
Oh, boy. I don't know what my freestyle is. All my stuff is taken now.
With nuts? Yeah, that's a problem. What could Matt do?
He can go sit in the corner while the big boys play.
Oh, the smack talk.
Or the sack talk.
This guy has to prove he can take one first. I already took it.
Yeah, Matt might not have to do freestyle because he's the one that came in here already. We'll figure something out for Matt in New York City.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure Matt could find something to rip off from one of us and, you know.
Love the smack talk.
Well, we can brainstorm. We can figure something out. By the time we get to Matt, maybe we'll have something.
How about you
have
to let Master Poe kick you in the balls a few times?
I think he wants to.
Silence. Yeah. Over the room.
How about Matt has to drink a cup of my cum?
Oh
my God.
Now that raises this to a fucking different competition.
This really is
sexiest.
I was going to say, it just got hot.
Well, cup of my cum.
Well, this is the real deal, though. Raphael is really pissed off
Raphael's
that Matt
a fucking problem.
Stole his thunder. He's a problem.
No, Matt Puerto Rican.
No, I know.
No.
As soon as you walked in, I realized I might judgment error.
All right, let's go to Pat in Boston. Pat?
Grr. Hey, I just want to know if these guys did any pregame. Did they get a bunch of loads out? Are they holding loads in for 3 days? What's the story?
Yeah, what was the pregame all about?
About you, you guys ejaculate or just save it?
I broke my finger so I can feel the pain.
He did break his finger. How'd you break your finger?
Actually work.
Oh, okay.
What kind of work do you do?
Construction.
Okay.
All right. I guess we're ready.
Yeah, absolutely.
Should we take a break and then set up the studio and we'll be ready to go?
And the festivities will start.
Yes.
Do we have like some dramatic music and all that?
Super Bowl Thursday. I think we need some of that NFL music or something.
Yes, maybe some AC/DC.
All right, we'll figure something out after the break. It's Super Bowl Thursday.
Yes.
And it's going to get crazy in here. The EMT guys are in here and they're ready to jump in if they have to. What about the bees? Had they been transported to the apparatus?
Yeah, how is that going?
We'll do it now.
Where are we going to do this?
Right in that little studio right there.
Right in this studio, huh? Mr. Fancy Pants?
I see you do it over there by Ope. Why not? He's got
Why not? Ope, you do it. Pick him out by hand and just throw him in the tube.
Yeah, you laugh at bees.
I do laugh at bees.
Where are the faggots?
Yeah.
What are you doing without your hat on?
I don't know. The bees aren't going to come out until fucking... You think I don't know this radio show? It's fucking 9:30. Bees will be brought out at 10:56. No, why would I wear that? It's uncomfortable when the bees are coming.
You just want to look good until you have to.
Yeah, the girls on Pal Talk want to see me. The complaints were flying in.
Just like the NFL where they take off their helmets to look good on the sideline. That's what Jimmy's doing right now.
No, this is staying on.
No, it bothers my head. It itches like the ear thing gets pressed down with the hat. I don't like it.
Sorry.
That's all right.
Fuzzy Numpkin calling again. Fuzzy!
Yo, what up, boys?
What's up?
Yo, you got the sequence all wrong. Check it out. All
right.
First, you got to slap the mousetrap.
Yep.
Then you got to do the wax.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Then they'll be, like, nice and fresh and red and open. Then you got to do the bees. Then to top it off, you hit it with the Bengay.
Yeah, but then that messes up the ultimate challenge.
Yeah.
Well,
it has to end with the bees.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then the ante gets up. The ultimate challenge becomes, can you get the Bengay on your balls after the bee sting?
I thought of that, too, but not for the same reason you're thinking. I thought of it because if the bee, will it deter the bees from stinging? We've already seen Nathaniel took it.
I don't think it will, though. I mean, if it did, people would be saying, hey, Bengay keeps bees away.
Well, no one's probably ever been put in that position where they put Bengay. Like, how many old people are outside and getting stung? Old people get stung all the time.
I'd love to see that. Just bees all over him.
Yeah, right on his joints where that fucking Bengay is.
The arthritis.
Yeah,
I can feel even worse.
But nothing happens because they got the leather skin. The stingers are just breaking in half. They're not penetrating anything. All right, Fuzzy.
Thanks, brothers.
All right.
No, we got to do the bees last.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
I'm a little concerned like Jimmy is, but it has to be last.
Okay. I think it'll be all right.
Like we said, we'll be more than happy to go in and wash your balls for you.
I think it'll be okay, too.
After that, Jimmy will get in and lather them up real good.
Why is it we and then Jimmy will get in and lather them up?
Well, hope he's got to dry them. And I got the bee suit on. I can't do shit.
All right.
These guys will wax like one side of their ball bag, so the other side is ready for the bees.
Just in case the Bengay keeps them off, they still have
An area to go to.
Yeah.
All right. Super Bowl Thursday begins next. All right, we're just about ready. We've just been informed that Bill the intern has to transport the bees.
Not yet.
From the jars and containers into the homemade apparatuses that Keith the Cop made. This is going to be like transporting plutonium.
With drunks.
Let me set the scene. Is the camera set? Because Pal Talk, there's so many people in the Pal Talk room right now.
Yeah, a lot.
It's the most people we've had in Pal Talk since starting the Pal Talk phenomenon.
Record so far. Over 500 people tuned in. To check this out, a lot more probably will be downloading it later because people post these video clips up on the web. And,
Where do they post these clips, by the way?
They're all over, on people's personal websites. There's secret
through
sites.
Through Whackbag or no?
Yeah, through whackbag.com.
Okay.
Because
there's a lot of people that don't have the Pal Talk and they're going to want to see video immediately.
You doing that in here?
He has to do it in here.
Has to do it in here. Jimmy, here's the deal.
Wait a minute.
Let me just set this up as Jimmy panics and tries to get his bee suit back on. There's hundreds of bees in these containers. We have to open up that lid and try to get a few into these apparatuses. I don't see how we're going to do this.
All right. Hold on.
We'll do it.
We're going to fun. Oh, my God.
All right,
this is a disaster waiting to happen.
Jimmy didn't hear. Jimmy, here's the problem. A couple of our guys are allergic to bees. They have to stay in the production room.
Hold on.
No bees can be exposed outside of this studio because then when they go and walk out, if a bee got away and stung them, there would be a problem.
Yeah, they're in a sealed studio over there. The ones that are allergic to the bees.
All the bees have to stay in this studio if any get loose.
Huh?
Which guys?
Danny's allergic and Travis is allergic.
Something I can put right there. Travis is not allergic.
Oh, my God.
Let me get something.
You don't...
Jimmy, your hands, Jimmy.
I know. I'm waiting for this. Hold on.
Got my ankles.
Oh, my God. This is just not going to work.
All right.
Is the camera set up nice?
I am so glad I am dressed like this now.
Holy
Those fucking bees are all riled up, too, boy.
Oh, they
woke up.
Pissed.
They just woke the fuck up. How are you guys going to do this? Have you ever done this before?
No.
Oh, my
God. No, this is uncharted territory. They haven't tested this funnel method either.
Yeah, mine will close up the funnel.
Yeah, because things with wings go right down funnels.
Another first Ropey
and
Anthony, by the way.
Flying out.
This is another first Ropey and Anthony, by the way.
Am I zipped up right up to the...
Yeah.
All
right, hold on.
You got to zip the middle up, Ant. What the fuck are you doing?
Jimmy, don't fuck with me. I'll kill you.
Oh, shit.
What are you, nuts? He just... Smash them bees
Anything
in there.
Done?
Gonna die. Nope. Holy shit, dude.
It worked.
Wow, it worked.
No one was looking and he just did it.
You did it perfectly.
There's fucking 80 bees.
Warman.
Dude, we didn't want 80 bees in one apparatus, though. We have to spread out the bees, or are they going to use the same thing? They're going to have to use the same apparatus.
They look friendly.
What?
There's some more bees here, and he has
There's plenty of bees left.
I got to say...
But it worked the first time. Why are we taking a chance?
It's
going to
work twice, Opie. Have faith in the man.
I was going to tell you, ready, set, go.
I have
nice
complete confidence in this guy's ability to transfer these bees.
Can I say those bees looked sleepy before, but boy, they're fucking wide awake now. That really...
Let me tell you.
By the way, show the Pal Talk camera the bees in the apparatus just to prove that there are a lot of bees in there. We're not fucking around today.
You just
today.
Hold it up to the...
Hold it up. Don't move.
See them in that tube.
Don't move.
You see all the bees?
See, now there's a slide thing, a door that's going to open up, and they're going to go into the other thing where the guys are going to have their balls. You guys still want to fucking do this? Who's going to bail?
Bees, man.
You're not that brave now, Raphael.
And they're hungry.
Oh, shit.
They're hungry
honeybees, though.
They're hungry.
You know damn well this is going to end in a disaster.
Wait a minute. Can't you... If you're opening the slide, you can let just a few of them in and close it, right?
Yeah, but the slide's really chintzy, so you got to really work.
What do you want to do, Jim? Stand there and give a thumbs up, thumbs down, or whoever gets in?
No, but I mean, like a fucking club. I'm just trying to meet my friend. He's in there. He's behind
Wait. You got to get a plug in. What do you want to plug today? This is the guy that brought in most of the bees.
Wormman.com.
Wormman.com.
We sold crickets
shit,
and
they're
bugs.
Pissed.
Look at the ones in the apparatus.
Oh,
they're starting to fly around in that pissed off bee-like way they do.
Yeah.
How would you feel?
Ah! All right, he's transferring the other bees.
Uh-oh.
Get it in there. Get it.
Nope, this one isn't going as smoothly.
That's a fucking honeybee. Why don't you guys act like men?
Oh, my God, I stopped breathing.
Like men.
The guy in the condo.
I stopped breathing. All right, we got two apparatuses that are fully loaded.
Oh, now I got a feeling like one's on me. Get off of me.
Fully loaded.
Yeah, no, Mike.
All right.
Wow, both. They are pissed in that one, man.
Yeah, now they're all
pissed off. Those
fuckers
woke up. They were sleeping for the winter, and now they got fucking... They're in an apparatus with balls ready to be put in. How would you feel? They're unpleasantly...
All right, guys. This is what's going to happen. So we got to figure this out. We got to figure this out step by step. When they start getting stung, they're going to freak out and drop the apparatus, and then all hell's going to break loose in the studio.
And I will laugh and laugh and laugh.
disarm the bee.
What do you got?
A bee. I caught one by the wings. He's ready to sting, so if you want to...
What the hell?
What do you want us to do with it?
You're a fucking insane person.
Don't let him go. He's holding him by his wings right now.
Yeah, put him back in and talk to him later. See how he feels about it.
Oof.
Let me ask, can you hear them? Can you hear them buzzing there or no?
No. The bees are in a soundproof booth, so they don't hear the answers.
Can they breathe in there, by the way?
Oh, boy. Does it matter? How much air do they breathe, really?
Oh, yeah, we don't need them all.
In there.
Imagine as soon as they... if I was one of these guys, I just wait for them to suffocate. Put your balls in when they're all fucking just not moving.
All right. I'd play dead.
By the way, we didn't even promote this, but Tracy Morgan's here. Just to make this
all
even
right.
Better. Yeah, bring up... Tracy Morgan is getting his B suit on.
Oh, Tracy Morgan's putting a B suit on?
He'll be joining the festivities. Tracy Morgan rocks. We met him a few years back at our celebrity softball game.
Yeah.
And he's been a friend ever since.
He is putting a B suit on.
Oh, this guy is a real trooper, man. Remember he went out to the pitching mound in front of 6,000 people in just a jockstrap?
In a jockstrap, and then he jumped in the pool. We had little kiddie pools with strippers in them.
Yeah.
And he jumped in and bathed with the strippers.
All right.
This guy will do anything.
All right, now we're just waiting for Tracy Morgan to get the bee suit on, and then mm-hmm. we'll get this going. So the bees are in the apparatus,
and
they're pissed off.
You know something? They really came alive, these bees, because they were kind of lethargic in the plastic containers.
Yeah.
But when they're in the apparatus now, I think they sense soon testicles will be joining them in there, and they're angry.
Where's the guy that's got the spray that kills them?
He's outside.
Oh, that's brilliant to have him out there.
Yeah. See, have you noticed all the protection is for outside of this studio?
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing going on in here. They don't want a bee getting out of this.
Yeah, give me that spray
compartment.
Because I don't have a bee suit on. At least give me the spray.
That's good. Just don't spray us.
I'll spray whatever I have to.
Don't spray all willy nilly.
Don't open the door. You'll flood the whole compartment. He's dead already.
Don't get it on your skin, really? Yeah. So if this guy has what happens?
Because it's a fucking poison.
Oh, okay.
How about giving a guy... Can you have a fucking magazine rolled up if a bee comes in? Don't spray chemical poison.
Oh, wow. He's like the... you're like the low-tech version?
Yeah, better than chemical poison.
Kind of smack him?
Yeah. All right. Tracy Morgan's just about ready to enter the studio. Is he... He's
close.
He's close? Okay. We have so many people in the studio. EMT guys, you ready?
All set.
They got their gloves on and everything, Anthony.
Yep. All ready to go.
And no one's allergic to bees in here?
Oh, shameless plug? You,
shameless
of course.
Got to thank the guys from Assist Ambulance. They donated the truck that's and a full set of crew that's here tonight. So
Assist Ambulance. Thank you.
Yeah, we got a full crew in-house.
Tonight, this morning, whatever. Yeah. I do the same thing.
Appearing at an accident near you.
I leave every day going, good night, everybody. It's 11 in the morning.
Yeah. All right, Tracy Morgan.
I'm afraid to pop my hand out just to work the mouse over here.
Yeah.
Here
you
go. The camera's set in a nice place, Anthony?
I think they'll think through that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
How do we decide who goes first?
Holy boy.
Shit, they look angry.
Huh? I don't know.
Raphael wants to go first. Who wants to go second? Steve?
I'll go second.
All right. And Matt's kind of like the champion here of what we don't know.
Chumplin. We should have them do it.
We're getting another camera in here to film this?
We have one.
We should get a two camera.
There are video cameras going, so what you miss or don't get a really good view of on Pal Talk, you could download later in beautiful digital quality.
Yeah, we should get two cameras going just
at
in case.
At that rapid, fast, high quality video that you can get off of foundrymusic.com.
Yeah.
Bandwidth like a thread.
All right.
God. Can you compress the files anymore? That's great. What was this? I can't tell. There's only three
Ladies
pixels.
And gentlemen, Tracy Morgan! In his bee suit!
Bro, Jimbo,
what up?
Tracy!
What are we doing in here, man? This is crazy, man.
He's got his Yankee cap on.
This is crazy, man.
What's up, Tracy?
So dudes are getting, like, stung on the nuts?
Yeah, maybe we should have told you ahead of time what was going on today.
This is so cool, man. I can't even get a chick to teabag me, and y'all letting bees sting you in the nuts.
Look at these. Don't open those
Yeah,
things.
Look at that. You see the angry bees in there, Tracy?
Look at that.
They're pissed off, right?
Oh, man, are they pissed.
Dude.
Are you African? They are pissed off.
They are the Africanized killer bees.
Yeah. Are you serious?
Yeah, as opposed to the pussy cracker bee.
Yeah.
Is what they call the ones raised
here. They're going to open up that part, shove their nuts in, and then we're going to release the bees in from that compartment to that compartment. And
who's
then
they?
These three lunatics.
Wow.
This has never been done on radio before.
Dude's crazy.
No, it's never been done
it's
on the planet.
Super cool, man.
No. On radio, really.
And we are here to witness this.
Yeah.
This is why this is the greatest show on earth right
In
here.
The safety of our bee suits.
You guys are the best.
How did you get gloves? You brought those yourself, huh?
Yeah.
God damn it, I wish I had gloves. I got to go around like this.
I know. Yeah. I feel silly.
I feel scared.
They gave this to me out there. They That's said, you want to go in? I said, yeah, I got to be here for this.
That's
yeah.
cool. What are we promoting today? Because we might forget real soon.
Whatever I'm promoting ain't bigger than this.
It's all right.
This guy's about to get stung on the nuts by
bees. You doing Caroline's?
You doing Caroline's?
Yeah, we doing Caroline's
all
tonight.
Weekend?
Yeah.
Oh, sweet. I'll be there.
Nice.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
All
you
right.
know me.
Tracy Morgan. Check him out at Caroline's. He's up.
Dude,
rip,
let's
man.
See this.
Yeah. yeah. Well, I want to introduce you to these guys. That's Raphael. Wait, raise your hand or something. There's Raphael. There's
Steve.
What's
going on, Tracy?
What's up, bro?
And that's Matt. He's the champion.
Wait a minute.
Well, it all started with. It's a long story.
These
but,
things?
No, this is great, actually. Raphael called our show one day and said, hey, guys, I want to take a mousetrap to the nutsack. Because we were doing it when we were bombing with our jokes, we were taking mousetraps to our hands. So he goes, fuck that. I'll take one to the nutsack. This guy came up with it. He goes, I could be in tomorrow. That was sometime last week. Matt goes, fuck that. I'm in New York City. I'll be there in an hour. So he stole this kid's thunder.
Yeah.
So Raphael really pissed off, and this is, and now we have this competition called Super Bowl.
It is like a going payback. Down.
It's going
it
down
is
now.
Going down in here.
And you're on a camera, by the way. We're doing a whole pal talk thing. There's a ton of people with their webcams checking us out right now.
Right on.
And they're just staring at you in your bee outfit. So
how do you feel, good. Man? How you guys feel about this, man?
Just do it.
Any thoughts?
There's like one bee in there waiting for your ass.
They are so pissed. I can't believe how much they've come alive, these bees. One thing I want to know, there are two apparatus and three guys.
What's the difference with these guys?
Those are the ones that didn't quite make it into the apparatus.
Yeah, they kind of got loose and we were able to catch them.
I want
to
know who, there are two guys, three guys and two apparatus. Who's going to get sloppy seconds
no way.
On the apparatus?
No way.
See, that seems to be the part that has these guys flustered.
I'll tell you what. I'll take one of the jars, put some bees in there, throw some tape on it. I'll throw my balls in the jar so all three of us can go at once.
Yeah. Well, someone's got. What about the wasps?
I think there's a wasp in there somewhere. Or,
where's the wasp at?
There's a whole combination of things in there. They're fighting.
They're willing to. Here's
these guys are here in case one of them have a heart attack or something.
Yeah.
Or at least me or Anthony do.
They need the.
They're EMT guys.
If they need some of that shit where so your throat don't close up if you're allergic. They're right there.
There's a possibility that one of these dudes could die.
Yeah. Yeah. See.
Yeah. Rock and roll, baby.
That seems to be the problem here.
You mean foam coming out the mouth and all of that?
The
shaking
whole
it?
Deal, man.
Yes, yes, yes.
Tracy gets it. All right.
Why am I wearing these?
One of you dudes might die, man. This is what a way to start
this
the
morning. This is the real deal, Tracy.
This
is the real deal.
I know.
Like it,
all right.
Really.
Yeah.
Anthony, I think we're ready.
I'm guessing, Jimmy. I don't know shit.
Tracy, we came up with a couple things they have to do before the... That's called the ultimate challenge, what you're looking at in front of you.
Okay.
Want to adjust the webcam?
Yep.
First of all, they got to take a mousetrap to their nutsack. Go old school. Where are the mousetraps?
Is it mousetraps or mice traps?
Mousetraps.
I think it's mousetraps, even though it doesn't...
Because each trap is for a mouse. Traps is pluralized, not mouse.
Very good, Jimmy. Thank you.
Thanks, Jim.
All right, the camera's now on the contestants.
Yep.
What's going to happen is, Anthony, you got to, like, work the camera. Like, no, where do you want them to stand when they're doing their thing?
Well, ideally, like it was last time, we got the best shot from where Jimmy is, but, you know, we got more people in here, and Jimmy's here, so
can
it's
we move
be
the
a
camera
little,
just a little closer?
No, we got no more slack left in the line.
Really?
We wouldn't get more than another inch or two closer, and that really won't make much of a difference.
Why don't you move the honeybees, the two remaining ones, out of the way? Yeah, just slide.
Well, you
want to
move Tracy over there, and then the guys where we were last time for this ant. Tracy could just move over there for this part.
We could do that. We can
with
do
these
that.
Guys?
No, no, you'll be on that side.
You just grab that mic, Tracy.
Mic
okay.
Grab that mic. Because we want a close up for the folks at home.
Yeah. Keep the bees off my latte.
All right, now I guess where Bill is would be ground zero for this whole thing.
Yeah, where Bill is looks like the best shot right there.
All right, Bill is setting up the mousetrap.
Dude, can
this
I
is Super Bowl Thursday on the Opie and Anthony program.
Are they going all three at the same time or one at a time?
One at a time.
This one.
One at a time. Oh, all right, so Raphael from Connecticut, he's stepping up to the mousetrap.
Raphael.
You know, you got to move the ultimate challenge away. The apparatuses, just to get a better camera.
The apparatus is a little in the way.
We need help here, guys. I can't broadcast and organize at the same time.
Choreograph this whole thing. Oh, geez, he's putting them near me. Ha! Huh? I am getting the heebie-jeebies so bad looking at those things.
All right. Mousetrap is set.
I think we can move the camera slightly closer. No.
No, we're pretty much we're there.
All right,
as close as we can get it.
And we got two cameras rolling just in case. Yep. Two different angles. Okay, here we go. This is Raphael from Connecticut.
Hold on 1 second. Oh, can you zoom it all in? I think you have zoom power with
yeah,
the camera.
Yeah, digital zoom. It stinks.
You try it one.
No,
try
it's
it
good.
Once.
I think it's good because we got a close up for later on for okay. OpieAnthony.com. This right, is at least
did,
good enough
I did
for
it once. It's not bad.
All right, yeah, keep it like that. All right, here we go. Raphael, whenever you're ready.
Now, remember, here's how it's got to be done, Raphael. You have to take your bag and stretch it out.
Yeah, Matt did this perfectly. You stretch it out.
You stretch your bag out and make sure it's only your sack that is going to be whapped by that thing. Make sure you push your testicles Smack. Back so it's Smack. Only bag skin that is being hit. You don't want to hit a nut. You just want sack skin.
Yeah.
This is pretty gay. There's like 25 guys in here Dude. And one female.
Oh, come on, come man. On. Go ahead and pull your sack
Tracy
out of the
Tracy Morgan's seat. Here.
Yeah. Let's see this shit go down.
Yeah, Tracy Morgan gays the whole thing.
All right, here we go. Wrap it up. He's got his sack out. It's stretched out. And here we go. We're filming this for OpieAnthony.com. Whenever you're ready, Raphael from Connecticut.
Wow, he's ready for another.
Oh, ready for another,
ladies and gentlemen.
Go for two. Set it up, Bill.
What a professional. What a moment for sport. I can't believe he's going for a second mousetrap, people.
Dude, don't even. Yeah. No one gives a shit about your junk. Trust me. Don't worry about it.
Wow.
All right, we got a second trap set and ready to go.
He's going for two.
Whoa. Misfire, misfire. Okay, Raphael's still got the mousetrap.
Bill's trying to set the traps.
Bill's shaking.
What's the matter, Bill? Oh,
Raphael is still has the mousetrap attached to his ball bag.
Of course he does.
And Bill is just having a real tough time reloading.
He's got the left
Give me the
side
trap.
Of his sack in a mousetrap, I believe. And he's going to go for the right nut.
Hit a nut.
Now,
here we go. Here's the second one from Raphael.
A dual watch this. Hit watch on
this.
The mousetrap.
We didn't see this coming, Anthony. Watch he's going this. For two.
Oh! Son of a bitch! Two mousetraps!
Oh my God!
Raphael from Connecticut kicking off this competition in true professional style. Unbelievable! Two mousetraps! No one saw that coming.
Let's get one on my taint.
Unbelievable. What a kickoff. What a kickoff to this Super Bowl.
I want another one. Come on, give me another one.
Well,
where would you
I got to find some more skin. I got to find some more skin.
Where would you fit a third?
Here, show the webcam. Show Pal Talk.
No one cares. Yeah, go ahead. Show him your
Don't move. Don't move.
Wow.
Jesus Christ.
Ow. Dude, you're brave.
Oh, he's loading
you're
up a
brave.
Third mousetrap.
All right, I got a third mousetrap. I'm heading
You know,
over
in the world of professional sports, it's moments like this, Opie, the unexpected things that happen that show the true professionalism. That's what's history
By
making.
The way, who's judging this?
Judging? What's the fucking judge?
Well,
let him just do this.
But I mean, in the end. We'll...
Oh, in the end, how do we pick a winner?
Yeah.
I have no fucking idea.
What does the winner get?
He is now trying to find more skin. He's pulling at different parts of his bag. I think on the left side, I found a little more. Perhaps you can squeeze it into the corner of the trap. It's all ball, though. Make sure you push that ball back.
No balls.
No ball. Just get skin. That's delicious skin.
There it is. He found some skin. He's going to have to go for the corner, I think. Not going to be able to dive straight forward into this one, Opie. He's going to have to come in on the corner.
All right.
With his ball bag.
Oh, you want me to push this forward a little bit?
Hitting the detonator. He was talking about your cock.
Hey, Jimmy, you want to hold this?
Push this forward.
All right, here we go. Raphael's going for a third mousetrap.
Come on,
third
Raphael.
One.
All right, let's...
here he goes.
You got balls, like, right there.
He's trying.
Be careful.
Yeah, watch that testicle.
Yeah, protect the testicles.
Here he goes.
Here we go, the third one.
Oh my God! Three mousetraps on his ball! Unbelievable!
Wow.
I wish I had more skin. I'd keep going, but I'm sorry.
It is just a lack of scrotal skin, Opie, that is keeping him from putting even more traps on there. I have not seen professionalism like this in sport in years.
This motherfucker should join the Marines
Anthony,
or something, yo.
Anthony, it's
kind of
weird.
Man.
I kind of like the pain, man.
Do
yeah.
you?
I like it, yeah.
Could you not look me in the eye like that when I say that? It's almost like an offer.
Sitting there, my boss sagging it off.
All right, let's hear it for Raphael from Connecticut.
Raphael, what a kickoff on this Super Bowl
Thursday.
2006. Wow, that is really going to be hard to beat. not only mousetrap to the nutsack, but a second and then a third mousetrap.
Right.
This is going to be hard to beat, ladies and gentlemen. Other contestants, are you nervous by the initial, the kickoff here by Raphael? Three mousetraps. How do you compete?
I'm sure I have enough sack for four.
He believes four mousetraps. Wow. This is something we didn't expect. I'm absolutely crying over here. Just being witness to this is fantastic.
It certainly is. Tracy, any comments so far?
Man, I have no comment on this, man. These dudes are super freaks, man.
This is unbelievable.
These are super freaks.
This is like watching Ali and Liston. This is like watching the 69 Mets in the World Series. Again, it's like watching the Mets beat the Red Sox. It's just a moment in sport that I'm going to say, where were you when they snapped three, four mousetraps on their bag? And I'm going to say, I have no idea I was drunk. Unbelievable day for sport.
There's actually, I have a bet with one of the EMTs. He said they won't make it through the mousetraps. I'm like, dude, you have no, they're going to make it.
Oh, yeah.
This is nothing.
The EMTs were doubting one mousetrap, and we've seen three. We have four loaded mousetraps here.
Just...
You had better have a huge sack, my friend.
All right, now we got
four traps.
We got Steve from Connecticut stepping up to the mousetraps.
Let me tell you something. Steve has an advantage. Raphael was uncharted territory with three mousetraps, Obi. He can now look and see and pick and choose where he wants to snap that first trap, allowing maybe more skin for the subsequent traps that will come. I think going second, a very good strategy here.
All right, here we go. Steve is stepping up to the mousetraps.
Here he goes, not afraid.
And he's not shy to show
everyone.
Not
shy, not afraid. Where's that first one going?
Hey, look Obi in the face while
he's
you do
pulling,
that.
He's pulling as much yambag over, exposing as much of the right side of his sack as he can. He's starting on the right side, I believe, working right to left. Right to left.
Here we go.
Here he goes, detonation.
Number one.
Closer, you goose.
Oh, there it is. He's got a mousetrap on the left side of his bag.
Didn't
he's
blink.
Pushing over. Oh, he's not even taking a second. Next trap lining
didn't
up.
Didn't even blink.
I do think he's going to be able to get two traps on that left side of his bag, leaving the right side completely open for at least two more
at
traps.
At least two more. Here we go. Steve
pushing
from Connecticut
forward.
Going for the second mousetrap.
Fantastic.
Fucking Steve. He's shaking. Are you all right?
Yeah.
He's stepping
trying
up to the mousetrap.
One fell off. I'll do it again. No biggie.
Uh-oh.
If one fell off.
Likes this.
Wow. Now you
like
know.
This shit.
Maybe you should break out the rat traps.
You will have to have four hanging in order to beat that three.
Yeah.
Here he goes. Having a really tough time keeping that nut out of there.
I know.
There.
It's not even cold
getting
in
enough
here.
Bag.
He is shaking.
He's perhaps, all ball, this kid.
You know, right now I believe he's probably wishing he just got out of a warm shower where you have that great Turkish taffy consistency to your yambag, which is perfect for this type of a
there
competition.
We go.
Oh, there it is. Back in. On the left side.
That's
it is hanging.
Yes.
That must
one.
Stay now. Hey, that is the second one's coming up.
All right.
You know, the studio was a little chilly today, and that could inhibit the number of mousetraps he gets in there. But as he goes on, he's warming up there. Two traps on his yambag. And now his the other side of his yambag completely exposed and open.
Ready for number
plenty
three.
Of room. He's got plenty of room
I love
for
how
another
these
couple
guys are
of,
shaking.
Mousetrap.
How's it feel so far, Steve?
It doesn't hurt at all. This is bullshit.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh.
See, that's professional.
Oh, that one had to hurt.
God damn it. Holy shit.
Fucking... He's going for number four.
He's going for four.
Oh, he's going for four. This is a record.
Yes.
Four. Three
what,
was a
Anthony,
record.
One was a record.
Here he goes.
Number four.
Number four. My God. This
will
is
be
just...
a new record.
Oh, my God. Oh. Opie, four mousetraps are hanging from his yambag. I've seen it all. I've seen it all.
Where's the camera?
You know, I've
camera?
Seen some
it's
things
there.
In my day.
There it is. Right there. Right there. No, dude, there's the camera right in front of you.
I'm trying to see if I can fit one more.
Oh, my God. Stop it.
One more. Let's see if we can do this.
I say go for it.
Opie, I've seen Nirvana in a small club. That's nothing
that one
compared if he does five five mousetraps.
Can you load that one?
Where do you think you're going to fit this one, sir?
Yeah, where?
Where? How much skin do you have there?
Are you going underneath? He's going way over to the right-hand side, pulling some bag from underneath up into the right-hand side. My God, he's finding bag where there shouldn't be bag.
What are you,
unbelievable.
What are you, Arabian?
He has found more bag.
Yeah, he's
under.
Has.
I think he's pulling up loose taint skin.
All right, here
he goes. If he gets five traps.
Here we go. Number five.
Oh my God!
One fell off, but he did have five.
He had five.
No, it's not official.
All right, it's not official. We can be waving it off.
Come on!
You're saying waving it off.
It wasn't a catch. You said he didn't have possession.
You never had complete control of the mousetrap.
Let's go.
Load it again.
Load it again, Bill. Take those.
He never had complete control of the mousetrap with his scrotum.
How are the bees doing, by the way? They still moving around?
They're probably watching, wondering where they fit into this fucking thing.
Yeah, no shit.
Like, what are we going to do?
All right, we're going for five again. Here's Steve from Connecticut. It's Super Bowl Thursday. And
nose that forward a little. There you go.
Here we go. Number five. Make sure it stays on. Oh, he's shaking.
Can somebody just use the star to hold it in place?
Somebody hold it for me.
Sure, I'll be happy.
Somebody was holding it for me.
They'll just hold it.
Okay, fine. Fuck it then.
Just hold it there.
All right, he's going for five. Hold on. Take your time. Oh, there it is. Five traps are on this guy's bag. Unbelievable.
Wow.
Hey, wait. What a great. This is going to be a ball bag that goes down in history.
That's enough to kill half a mouse baseball team.
We got to go to Jim in Wisconsin. Jim?
Yeah, three. There's a little controversy here. Somebody ought to check for some performance-enhancing drugs like Novocaine.
Have a nice day.
All right, we will be checking for some type of steroids or performance-enhancing drugs. You know, to see five mousetraps like that, sure, the crowd enjoys it. The people love the competition. But what is it telling the kids? If they're using drugs and a normal person, you know, can't get any more than maybe two on there. You're getting five. I'm a little suspect here, but I'm not going to ruin this fine day for sport by bringing up this. Maybe an investigation later, maybe something. But right now, I'm just enjoying the competition. Which is fantastic.
It's anyone's game at this point.
Anyone's game.
Steve and Raphael, both very impressive.
When I think I was stunned at three traps, Opie, three traps, and this gentleman, five traps, no way to beat it. I just don't see enough skin.
Hey, kids, don't try this at home.
Very good. You are a role model.
You
so that's
certainly
a good
are.
Thing to say.
All right, Matt is stepping up. Matt, comment, anything? Did we lose Tracy Morgan already?
Where did Tracy go?
He said he had enough. He walked out.
Are he left us?
Yeah.
What?
Oh, he's over there? Yeah. What happened to Tracy?
Why was he outside?
Was he laughing hysterical at white guy cock?
Yeah.
Probably it.
I know. Black guys can get five on each side of the bag.
Interesting underwear.
Yeah,
he's
nice fucking silk.
I guess maybe he doesn't want to.
Jesus Christ.
Image of a
I guess
cop.
He doesn't want to get arrested, maybe. Maybe that's
maybe
it.
He's got some things he's worried about.
Separating himself from.
All right, Matt. Matt, what are you going to do to beat these guys?
I'll let my cock do the talking right now.
Do you think you could get more than five traps?
What's your cock going to say besides ouch?
He's really searching for the proper skin placement now.
Well,
that seems
numbers.
To be very important. Yeah. Now it's all about the numbers.
All right, here we go.
So you can't just go into this and snap the trap.
Here's Matt. From New York City.
Oh, there's one. Oh, Jesus, man. That's got to hurt. You're kidding me. That has got to hurt. Wow.
All right, he's going for number two, Anthony.
You want to move that a little closer,
yeah,
son?
You can move the trap
Don't
closer.
Don't be such a goose.
That's good. Yeah, it's all you. Any technique, any style. Wow, he's stretching that out like a full mouthful
of
Hubba
Bubba. Oh, he lost the mouse trap.
He lost the first mouse trap.
That's a tough one. He'll get it back on.
That one's got to go back on, sir.
Yeah, please.
All right.
Stop cheating.
He's going for number
wow.
one again.
Oh, my God. Oh, two traps sprung. But well,
his hand hurts. He shook his hand.
Barely hanging from...
That can't count. He hit his hand.
From his sack.
It counts. He has a broken hand. And he just
he does
a
have
trap.
A broken hand, which, again, shows, Opie, the courage of the competitors here today. Broken hand and all. And that didn't stop him. He's here for Super Bowl. A real trooper.
There's number two.
There's two. Again, he got that hand.
He keeps getting his broken hand.
Yeah, he's got two on his yam bag, but his finger hurts when he gets that slammed in there. Figure that. I don't know how this guy is wired. But very good. Like I said earlier, he's got a very good Hubba Bubba, chewed Hubba Bubba consistency to his yam bag, which I think will really help him get those numbers up.
And here goes number three, Matt from New York City, Super Bowl Thursday. He's out of camera range, by the way.
Yeah, I'll have to move
That's
that
all
over
right.
a bit.
That's all right. There you go.
There we go.
All right, he's got three hanging.
He's got three.
Three are hanging from his yam bag.
How's it feel, Matt?
Feels good.
he's digging it.
All right, he's going for number four. Number four is
unbelievable.
Loaded and ready to go.
Oh, it hurts.
It hurts. Yeah, I don't doubt
somebody
it.
Somebody owned up to it. There you go.
It does hurt.
Oh, there's number four. There's four. He still has some skin left. Good placement. Good strategy.
Yeah.
He's lining up his money.
You know, some people just think this is about slapping your ball bag in a mousetrap and taking the paint, Opie. But there is a true strategy here where you're placing these mousetraps on your yam bag. And I see, as he goes for five, mousetrap number six loaded and lined up. And I believe a very optimistic Bill is loading up trap number seven. You're insane, Bill. You're insane. It ain't going to happen. Not this year.
Matt from New York City going for the fifth mousetrap.
Hanging it way over the side. Wow, he is really hard to keep into
a camera.
He's moving side to side.
He's looking to see if he has room for six, Anthony.
Room for six.
Six would be a new world record.
This is something I have never seen before, and I gotta, you know, it's a moment I want to tell my grandchildren about.
Here he goes.
It's a moment they would love to tell their grandchildren about if they could have kids.
Attempting the world record.
He's actually reaching back and pulling asshole skin to the front.
Yeah, here it is.
Oh!
A new world record!
He's going for seven, Anthony! He's going for seven!
No way! No way! Not
what a
seven!
Champion.
And do I see mousetrap number eight waiting on deck? I refuse to believe this is even possible.
The only thing that's going to stop this kid is lack of skin. That's
right.
All that's going to stop him.
Lack of skin. The drive.
Here we go. Number seven.
That's a tough spot he's picking over there.
Yeah.
Seventh
mousetrap.
I don't know about this.
To the ball bag.
I think he's going to have to go more for part of the upper penile skin and lower penile skin, upper yambag skin.
It's still officially nutsack, but it's getting a little too close.
He's rifling through these like a janitor looking through his keys.
Yeah.
Number seven!
Oh, my God. Wait, do we have one that fell?
Yes.
Oh, my God. It's only six. Still
only
six. I thought we were seeing history in the making.
We still have a world record in front of us,
Anthony. Yes, we do.
Yes.
Oh, it snapped on Bill's hand.
All right.
Like, that really hurts after watching this. Have you found any open real estate, you think?
Matt, he's just concentrating. Matt?
Yes.
Another problem with this, Opie, is finding the skin. You keep pulling thinner and thinner layers of skin out because so much is taken up by the previous traps, which makes it even more painful.
All right, here we go.
Get it set. Let's go.
Number seven.
Yeah,
come on,
hurting.
Stop taking your time, Bill.
Wait, get on camera because this is for
here we go.
Another world record. Hold on a minute.
Stop IMing me, you motherfuckers! I can't see the goddamn camera.
What are they saying?
Wait. Hold on, Matt. We're trying to get you on camera. On Pal Talk camera.
There it is.
Okay, you're on camera again. He's been moving around like crazy.
Anyone IMs me, they get banned.
Here goes number seven.
Somebody hold the back of the
trap. Yeah, hold the back of the trap.
Yeah, hold, please, Bill.
Bill, it's not gay.
Yeah, it's not at all. Hold it with your chin.
It's not gay.
Yes, it is.
All right, he's going for seven. Seven mouse traps.
Oh,
no.
Oh, no.
I don't think it's going to happen.
It ain't happening.
Yeah, reset it, son. But give him one more chance, Opie.
He got three attempts.
Give the kid another chance.
I think he got three attempts.
Someone's on the phone going, could you imagine if Ben played this game?
Yeah.
Oh, forget
he's going for 47. He'll never make it.
You know those containers you see on your way to Jersey? The shipping containers? You need one of those filled with mouse traps for Ben.
All right.
All right, we're trying.
We'll give him one more shot at seven mousetraps.
Yeah, we're going to stop at
this
seven.
This is the last shot he's going to get at this.
Right at the edge.
Right at the edge. Bill, just hold the back of the trap for the guy so he can
just
set his world record.
Bill. Yeah, Bill, pull his tag out.
But did they tell, you know, Bruce Jenner not to attempt the final part of his
Wait, is it official?
One fucking fell.
Another fell.
There is only six.
It's just a skin issue, but six is the record.
Sir,
six.
That is more than respectable. Six mousetraps are hanging
Matt
from
New York City.
All right.
Unbelievable day for this competition.
Let's go to the phones. Larry in New Jersey. Larry.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
This is so painful.
That's why I'm the champion. It's the chief.
The radio.
You're a gentleman and a scholar.
And the worst part about it is I can't even, like, there's nothing even on shitty terrestrial radio to listen to otherwise.
Right.
I have to listen to this pain while I'm driving to work with my legs crossed. I'm going to get in an accident because I'm going to get my fucking foot off the brake here.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Jesus Christ. Right.
We are up to about 650 people.
All right.
That are watching this competition now. You know how it starts out like that. By next year, Super Bowl. I'm sure we'll have millions of viewers around
millions of viewers as
it is brought to network television.
And sponsorships, yes. The Ultimate
Perhaps
Challenge
ESPN.
Is still waiting for the boys, if, just in case you're tuning in to Super Bowl Thursday.
Oh, we are far from through, ladies and gentlemen.
We're
the
mousetrap
is just
though.
The beginning.
Yeah, what's next?
We're running out of show. We should move right on.
Right on to the wax?
The wax strips.
Wax strips. Let's have the wax strips and our competitors, athletes as I like to call them, Opie, up here. Wow. How about that?
Let's go to Jerry in Jersey.
And what will the grounds crews be wearing to remove those mousetraps from the studio?
Jerry!
Yeah, fellas,
what's up? Listen to this one.
I'm sitting at home listening to this, and I got my hand on my ball sack trying to figure out how many mousetraps I can fit on it. Does that make me gay?
I swear to God, I was doing the same thing. I'm like,
There is no way.
I don't think I could do seven.
I actually have calculated, and the answer is zero. None.
Yes,
ever.
None.
I'm Irish. I can only fit one.
All right. Thank you, sir.
You guys suck.
All right, those are the wax strips that Bill has taken out. I see a container of Icy Hot right next to it. These are wax strips used normally, I guess, to bikini wax or girls get waxed with. Mustache wax, ladies, anything?
All right.
For the Italian girls out there?
Ooh.
Stop. A lot of them do.
Oh, my God, is that sticky.
A lot of them do. Is it?
Oh, my God. God, dude.
Yeah, that's going to hurt.
Fuck that.
Oh, I thought you were touching the wax strip and not Raphael's bag. Yeah, that is sticky. It looks sticky, Jimmy.
Hey, did we lose Tracy Morgan?
Yeah.
He didn't want to be part of this? He just said, what?
He just tapped out.
He tapped out.
I
Tracy
can't
Morgan
believe
tapped
it.
Out.
Why?
We can do this all at the same time. Yeah.
Did he get a phone call from someone who told him maybe it's in his best interest not to be on this show?
Probably the
We're the friends that your parents tell you not to hang out with, and don't go over their house because you'll just get in trouble.
Still love Tracy Morgan. He'll be at Caroline's all weekend long. He'll come back tomorrow. Why was he mortified? He's a little too Hollywood these days, I think. He's got people around him.
Yeah.
Well, he just didn't like looking at guys' balls. He said, I'll come back tomorrow.
Do you think we enjoy this? This is for the listeners.
That's right.
This is for sport.
We sacrifice for our fans. Hey, Ben, who else is here?
You ask both.
Ari's here?
Yeah.
I don't think some people take this sport seriously.
Yep, you're right. They look at it like it's a game.
Like it's some kind of a joke instead of a true sport.
We're going to the celebrity bullpen, by the way. We lost Tracy. We had to take him out of the game. We got Ari coming in from the Sopranos.
Ari!
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm kind of scared to come in this room.
Yeah, it really is nasty.
That is something to watch.
Does it just reek like awful sex in here? It probably does.
Yes, it does. It
smells like a... Ugh.
Wait a minute. You're from Dog Sees God.
I'm from Dog Sees God.
I thought they said you were from The Sopranos. You were on there?
I was also on The Sopranos.
What were you on The Sopranos?
Back in the day, I was Meadows College roommate.
Yeah.
I pulled out my hair.
Remember the crazy girl?
I was crazy, yo.
Yeah.
That was actually a really good
Not
role
Not as crazy
on the
as these guys, but, you know...
Hey, I don't always wear this, by the way.
It looks very becoming on you. You should wear it all the time.
Something I come in with on Thursdays.
It looks good.
Thank you.
It looks really good.
All right, so what do you got to do to wax this off? We're running out.
Okay, so basically warm it up in hand, apply really firm, and I guess they're ripping it off.
Yeah.
Okay, I think all three of them should do it at the same time because we have enough and time issues. So.
No, I think they
one at a time because you want to get the reaction.
We need reactions.
That's why you're still an intern, Bill.
That's right.
Are you offended by male nudity or anything like that?
I love male nudity.
All right, very good.
Bring it on.
And Tracy Morgan doesn't, by the way.
And Ari is making it less gay, thank God.
Yes.
We needed a female.
Finally, a lady is in here.
It is a little homoerotic in here.
It's a little.
Yeah, a little. And why add the word erotic? It's just. Just homo.
Yeah. Two men in beekeeper outfits with erections.
Yeah, do they look ridiculous, Ari?
No, it's good. It's a look.
I got a little beekeeper hat for my head.
We're running out of show. I'm telling you.
Yeah, guys, now that there's a lady in here, you can't be shy. You're going to have to slap that on
out.
There.
Yeah, come on. Don't be shy. Just do it.
Raphael is up first. Here goes Raphael from Connecticut. He was very impressive in the mousetrap challenge, Anthony.
Ugh. Wet Chicken, NH, you're banned. You're banned. Goodbye.
What's he saying?
Bounce that person. IM'd me. Interferes with my camera shot. You're gone. Goodbye. You missed the fun.
I was like, what the fuck? All right, guys, we're ready. He's got the wax strip on his ball bag. That's got to be tender and sore from the mouse.
Oh, my God.
From the mouse traps.
It looks like a fruit roll-up.
All right, the wax strip is on.
Right,
this is going to be child's play, I think, for Raphael.
Oh, that's nothing. Come on. Bring the glue traps in.
I agree.
Jesus, come on. Bring the glue traps
in. What, nothing?
I got to do it again, though. What the f-
All right.
Maybe you're not doing... Do you have hairy balls?
Yeah.
Yeah. Very proud of them.
Yeah, hairy sticky balls now.
Yeah, that's true. After a fucking...
Yeah, this is nothing after the
mouse. Which is good. It's kind of... It's sticky, so the bees will probably stick to them now as they try to escape. All right, that ripped a little hair out.
Yeah,
that
took a little hair out.
Yeah,
that
hurt.
This is child's play. Yeah, I'm disappointed.
After all the mouse traps. Look at this.
Wait, how many mouse traps did you fit on there?
He fit four.
Four. I didn't strategically place him on my sack. I would like a recount, maybe.
The excuse has come in, and he's blaming it on coaching. You know, this is something we don't need in professional sport like this, is the excuses, the blaming, the finger pointing.
All right, Steve is up next from Connecticut. He's got
Steve
the wax
from Connecticut.
You got some hairy bag.
He doesn't care. No, he's
got the head caught in the
Did they get that on camera?
Oh my god.
Ari, what do you think?
Holy. This is the most horrifying thing I've ever seen.
That looked like
Anthony,
it hurt.
Explain that if you can. It's worse than trying to pull Turkish taffy off of fly paper. It stuck to it. It was like an old fruit roll-up.
You know, on a hot summer day, you step on a piece of gum on the sidewalk, Anthony, and you're pulling and pulling, and the gum is still on your shoe.
Smash it on there, real good.
Wait, here goes Matt attempting
the
wax strip.
The shaft in there.
Don't bend down, or then you're not going to see it on camera. Yes.
Lift it up from the back to the front.
Here we go.
Like that.
Here we go.
Yeah, here we go.
Here we go. Ari, this is for you, Ari.
Hit it.
No, toward the camera.
Oh!
Did you hear the rip? Did you hear the rip?
Wait. Dude, hold on.
That hurt, right?
He's fucking falling.
Oh, wow.
He made it through.
The wax strips.
That hurt more than the mouse traps, Matt? Safe to say?
Yes.
Safe to say.
Wow, unbelievable.
All right, all the guys made it through the second stage of Super Bowl Thursday.
And remember, people at home, don't try this. These are professionally trained athletes that
have been training for minutes
to do this.
You guys aren't going to make me do anything like this.
Well,
we're
hoping, Ari. We're hoping.
We only Let me tell you something, Ari. We only have one competition we've ever had the ladies do. We haven't had it done in quite a while, and I really don't think you'd be up to it. It is called the Wiffle Ball Bat Challenge. See the Wiffle Ball Bat in that glass case up there?
It's protected in the glass case.
Say no more.
All right. All I'll say is it's a special kind of lady that even tries to compete.
I'm sure that's true.
Yeah.
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 Usually they're strippers or some type of porn star that goes for that. You could see their notches and names at various points on the bat, which I think you can figure
out
why. They weren't just drawing their names willy-nilly on that bat.
We want Ari to hang out a little longer, so let's...
Yes.
Now, are we done with the wax strips? Yes?
Yeah, that was the wax strip segment. Now, Icy Hot applied right to where the wax strip pulled off whatever it pulled off. Hair, meat... anything else?
This should be easy.
Yeah, they're going to laugh at
this. I can't believe you're still smiling.
Let me go to Robert in Dallas. Robert!
Yeah, everyone's talking about how painful this seems, but it's so surreal, I can't even imagine it. It doesn't even affect me. I have to see the video or something.
You got to see the video. Definitely. This is video that will...
It's the fucking worst thing you've ever seen. It's like it looks like it hurts more than the Kennedy assassination.
Let's go to Mike in Jersey. Mike?
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, Mike.
Hey, I had a quick suggestion.
Yeah.
I was thinking, how about a zipper to the ball sack?
Oh, zipper to the ball sack.
Oh, that's that could be a problem.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, boy. No, I don't think we'll see that.
Oh, boy. That could be a problem.
That's enough. Someone said that last wax thing sounded like Velcro.
It was
being ripped. Yeah. It really did make a nice
It came through loud
noise.
And clear, I believe, yes. All right, here we go. Fucking Norton drinking Starbucks
through his bee suit.
Bees moving still?
Oh, they are very active.
Don't shake them up. Come on.
You know what's happening, Opie? A lot of people in here, it's warmed up in the studio, and the bees are really coming around now.
The bees are watching this fucking disgusted.
What are we going to do with the bees?
What are we going to do with the bees?
That's the grand finale. As you see this rubber top, what they will be doing is inserting their bag into the top of that. A gate will be open, and bees will be released into there.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that's the grand finale.
That's the grand finale, yes.
Wow.
That's better than watching the Rolling Stones.
This is a perfect day. You really picked a good one.
Ari, by the way, is in the play Dog Sees God.
Yes.
And I saw that play.
You did?
And we had, what's his name, that dude that plays...
Eddie,
that from American Pie that plays Charlie Brown in the play.
Right.
We had him in here for over an hour, and he failed to tell me what the play was about. It. So I was for a huge surprise when I went and saw it, by the way.
Well, it's a good show.
It's a little gayer than what's going on in here.
I don't know about that. I really don't know about that.
And you were unbelievable, by the way.
Thank you.
You
so
played
much.
Marcy. Marcy. She was great in the play. It's still playing?
Yeah, it's open ended.
What's the matter, son?
Wait, what's wrong?
Why are you giggling?
Why is Raphael?
Problem?
My balls are really, really, really sticky.
And they're sticking to your
leg. I could demonstrate on the counter over here. You're going to have to sanitize it afterwards.
That's
anyway.
Why I sit and eat every day. Go ahead. Stick your balls there, son. Feel
watch,
free.
Watch, watch.
Oh,
it's sticking to the table. There you go. Enjoy your eggs tomorrow morning, Jimmy.
My fucking sleeve will get stuck to the counter where his bag was.
Hey, why is it sticky over here? Yeah. All right, what are we doing? Icy Hot?
Yeah.
You did it already?
No, I didn't put it on yet, no.
All right.
All right, Icy Hot right there. We're going to have to keep moving along here.
Guys, you're going to laugh at Icy Hot.
Icy Hot right where the...
Now, how much do we put in our hands?
Just the tip of your finger. You don't have to lather them up really well.
We should load them up. This is the ultimate.
You know what? I say we bail on the Icy Hot and go right to the ultimate challenge.
I agree because you don't know how it's going to affect it.
Because I just don't see the Icy Hot being that impressive after what we just saw.
All right. These guys showed themselves as
Hold on, they do have freestyle.
Yeah. Freestyle.
Just bring in Chomper.
Freestyle.
All
right, this guy Raphael has something called the Chomper. Where's the Chomper?
I don't know. It might be out there with the lawyers.
All right, go get the Chomper.
The lawyers. Look at him mocking the lawyers.
And Steve, he wants to go freestyle and do a cup of tea.
He's going to take hot water. Now, they came up with these ideas. We didn't.
Yeah.
He's going to take a hot cup of water and...
Here's the Chomper.
Oh my God.
All right, that's going to hurt a lot.
All right, that's called the Chomper.
Do you know Master Po could take out an army of 600 people with that thing?
You want Master Po to do the Chomper?
No.
Are you going to have your girlfriend? No. Is that your girlfriend? Yeah. Your fiance, right?
Yes, my fiance, Jessica.
Hi, Jessica.
How are you?
You're a lucky lady.
Yeah.
Wow.
She gets to chomp my balls.
All right, here's freestyle. Raphael from Connecticut is doing what's called the chomper. It's a, what is that, a plastic?
For pasta?
Yeah, a little
it's
pasta.
It's one of those pasta spoon things that you take it out and it's got like fork thong.
It has a lot of claws.
Tines on it.
Yeah, a lot of claws
and,
on it.
Yeah, claws to hold the pasta in there.
Do you hit his balls with things at home? Have you ever?
No, this is going to be the first time.
Okay. First time for everything.
I hope she's not mad at you.
Hold on. Cable?
Get elevation.
Harder.
All right.
I don't think that's going to hurt.
All right. Here we go.
Yeah.
I'm having a hard time spreading my sack open. It's all stuck like fucking
that'll happen.
A honeycomb.
That'll happen.
All right. Here we go. He's...
Yeah, it'll be fun.
He has released the ball bag again.
Just awful.
His fiance
don't
has
hit my
what's
head.
Called the chomper.
That's what he says when his cock is there. Don't hit my hand.
I mean, that's a nut right there. Hold on.
All right, yeah, no nuts.
I might be able to stick my balls right to the counter and just lean back. Whoa, that's a nut.
All right, here we go.
Oh, Jesus.
This is the chomper.
Oh, Jesus, the chomper. We're
it's
freestyling.
It's live on Pal Talk right now. People are checking this out at home.
It's competitor's choice, freestyling.
Wait, you're going to grab a ball?
Oh, she hit me in the fucking head!
Oh.
He miscalculated.
No pain, no hit? Gain. And there was
she hit your helmet.
Plenty of gain there. She hit the helmet.
Wow. All right.
Wow. Oh, he is in pain.
Matt's not happy. What's wrong, Matt?
I'm trying to think of a freestyle thing.
Yeah, Matt's panicking because we added the freestyle part to the competition.
Yep.
Yeah, the wiffle ball bat.
Wiffle ball bat challenge.
All right, where's the hot steaming water there?
I don't know. Where's the water? It was just
for the
here.
Tea competition.
Yeah,
the tea freestyle.
Do you believe they actually put a tea bag in there? Why?
Why not?
Yeah.
You might as well not waste it.
Yeah.
Because he likes yellow tea.
There it is.
How hot is it, Bill?
Oh, my God.
What's made?
How
you requested milk and sugar, too. So.
This seems almost worse than the chomper.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does.
Hold on. Before you take it out.
Yeah,
oh, that's fucking hot.
It is a...
that's going
to
be a problem.
Gives a new meaning to teabagging.
All right.
I just want to be clear. This is all just to get a radio. Is that right?
I don't even know what they're getting.
No, it's bragging rights.
It's pretty much bragging rights.
It's a guy thing.
It's not always about materialistic things. Sometimes it's just about sitting in a bar and saying, you know what I did?
We will figure out some really good prizes for these guys.
I don't know.
All right, here's...
Oh, my God. This is
oh, he's stretching. Wow. Yeah. Oh, he's pulling him down. Jesus, dude.
Smart move.
It's not a doorknob, all right?
He's good. That won't attract bees more. Nice milk and sugar on your balls.
Yeah, really.
Here he goes. And here he goes.
Yeah, let him steep it. Let him steep. Let him steep a bit.
Jesus.
Dip it in there already, you goose.
Dip it.
Oh, yeah.
All right, you don't have to drink it, Bam.
He dipped his balls in hot water and drank some.
Oh,
lovely. It's a lovely radio show.
Someone's saying, I can't wait to see Web Junk 20 this week on VH1. Oh. Mm-hmm. All right, well, Matt, anything?
I can do the icy hot, but...
All right, don't worry. I think it's time for the ultimate challenge.
Yeah, I say so, too.
Should we take a break before the ultimate challenge? Are we behind on breaks? Does it matter? All right, we'll keep going, yes.
All right.
We
look at
well
people screaming, no breaks, no.
Well, I just want to make sure we weren't behind, that's all.
No, we're not going to leave the tea for Fez. Ari. People have great ideas, but no.
As we get the ultimate challenge ready, let's talk to Ari for a few minutes here.
Yes.
So the play is happening. You want to explain to people that are listening for the first time?
Yeah, Dog Sees God is a play that's sort of about the Charlie Brown characters when they're in high school. But it's an unauthorized parody, and the names have been changed, and it's sort of inspired by these characters.
I completely noticed that when I was sitting there watching.
You knew
I'm like,
it. You guys,
I'm like, yeah,
smart.
I don't think Charles Schulz approved this play.
Yeah.
No, it's, you know, things are totally fucked up, and Snoopy has died, and... People are dealing with their sexuality and doing drugs and having sex and figuring out who they are. And it's a really, really fun show. Did you guys both see it?
I saw it.
Oh, thanks.
I was shocked by the gayness.
No, I'm going with my girlfriend.
Are you?
Yeah.
I was shocked by the gayness of the play, but besides that, it was really funny and well done.
It's a great group of people. There's 8 of us in the show, and it's a great cast. Eddie was here, as you said, mm-hmm. and Les Jushku and Kelly Garner and Logan Marshall Green and Keith Nobbs and America Ferrera and Ian Somerhalder, and it's
how does he open mouth kiss every night?
Do they really open mouth
kiss? Well, I look like that from my angle.
Well,
because we've had a discussion on the show lately because of the Brokeback Mountain and stuff. We're like, and you're an actress,
yeah.
And I don't get like why you would agree to. It would just be so uncomfortable. I'm thinking every night.
It's like one of those things. It's such a great. It's such a great show, and there's so many other. You know, and as an actor. You know, like, it's a challenge to do that or to play someone, you know, so it's like...
I usually don't feel this ridiculous doing an interview with a guest,
but
I'm like, I'm shaking my head like, yeah, yes.
Between and the beekeeper's outfit and, like, people's ball sacks hanging around and the bees on the table.
Ari,
and
I got one question for you. Are you going to ever forget us?
Never.
That's right.
Eddie, I heard Eddie saw some titties while he was on here, and I was like, how am I going to beat that? I'm going to have to see something. And
we had a lot of fun with Eddie.
I definitely got more
I just
than...
wish he would have warned me about the play.
You loved it.
I did you like it. Honestly, it. I did like it. It was definitely a really good play. I encourage people to go check it out.
And me and Kelly Garner, we have some pseudo-lesbian moments together.
When you guys... When you guys first hit the stage, that scene is unbelievable. It really
we're
really
in some extremely
tiny
extremely
outfits,
short skirts, and
yeah,
nice.
All it's right. good. Come on by.
And what theater is it at?
It's at the Century Center on 15th Street. It's great. We have a lot of young people. It's great because with theater, a lot of times it's an older crowd, but this show is so fun. It's an hour and a half. And there's something for everybody. And we have a lot of repeat visitors. People that have been 11 times and... People love it. People really love it. And now we're plastered all over the subways, and you can see.
And it's Dog Sees God.
Dog Sees God.
Every night of the week?
Every day except for Tuesdays. And on Fridays and Saturdays, we have a 7 o'clock show and a 10 o'clock show. 10 o'clock shows are great. It's like a rock concert. Friday nights are $25 tickets.
Right.
It's great. And we have a website, dogseesgod.com.
Are you allergic to bees?
No, but you're not going to sting me, are you?
No. We're just accidentally, we don't want any of these to get out. That's hence the... EMTs here.
Okay.
And I will protect you with my spray.
Okay.
Jeez, that sounds horrid.
Please don't ever say that to me ever again.
All right. I guess we're ready for the ultimate challenge.
I think so.
The problem is we only have two containers and three people.
I understand. They're going to have to share.
So, yeah.
They shared mousetraps.
Yeah, you shared mousetraps.
Exactly. It's not gay, believe me.
I think we should roll the dice or something to figure out who goes first or something.
How about whoever, yeah.
Paper, rock, scissors, pulling straws, what? What do you want to do? Smallest cock. I mean,
how do you flip a coin with three people? Who has the edge?
I think my belt speaks for itself that I should go last.
All right, Matt, that's good.
All right, good point. Matt is the champion.
Well, they should flip a coin for who has to go in which one. Cause
they're both pretty full, dude. There's,
yeah.
What do you want, 80 bees or 74 on your balls? Who cares?
The only problem is...
What problem?
Well, I think we should open it up and get the bees into the main container first, just so... Because this thing's hard to open the safety hatch, and if they're doing it that way...
Hey, here's the problem with that, though. Once the bees are in there, if they have a problem getting their bag in there before it gets sealed, there's going to be some loose bees in here.
That's right, Bill.
It's going to be someone's responsibility to open that gate.
That's right.
I don't care what it takes.
I think I'm
balls go in first, gate open second.
Absolutely. Good point, Ant.
That's what happened at Chernobyl. They opened the gate first and put the balls in second.
You
now look.
Put your balls right in there.
So, yeah. Do you want to just have Raphael call heads or tails for who goes first here?
Yeah, let Raphael do it.
Nathaniel?
What is it? It's tails.
Tails it is.
So,
Fez!
From Ron and Fez, everyone. Very surprised that you're in the studio.
Well, I got here a little early today. Can I say, finally, great radio. My God, this is what the country has been waiting for. Super Bowl every single day is what I said.
Fez, we had girls coming in here doing the Wiffle Ball Bat Challenge. Three of them were up on the console.
Really?
Where were you that day?
I don't recall that day. But yeah, I just happened to get in here early to do some paperwork over some things with Black Girl. Just great show, guys. This is the best.
Why are you pulling up a chair, Fez?
Why can't we do this every day?
Don't you have show prep to do or something?
Oh, fuck that show.
Oh, all right. Well, I'm glad you're enjoying it.
Yeah, this is the best. What's next? What's coming up next here?
Well, we have the ultimate challenge. This is the grand finale. The apparatus full of bees. The guys will be putting their balls in that hopefully airtight rubber top, and then a gate will be open, releasing the bees into the chamber.
Yeah.
And then they have to sit there until one of them gets stung.
This was one of many prototypes. We had to figure out an apparatus.
This is old Nazi technology.
I know. Yeah. One prototype was Jimmy Norton's mouth. And that didn't work out too well.
Yeah, I don't
He's
want
afraid
bees.
Of bees.
I don't want bees in my mouth. Well, I'm glad we all had a laugh at my expense.
here we go. Wow, I am now... into the frightened portion of the show.
I've never had an anxiety attack. I think I'm having one.
Yeah, this is a little much.
I'm getting a little freaked out
now. I understand
why
Tracy left.
Yeah, see,
but you're showing you have more balls than Tracy Morgan.
She's not going to be able to
handle this.
She's seeing more balls than Tracy Morgan.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, now, how do we decide? Is it who goes first or both at the same time?
I think, shouldn't it be both sequential or...
Yeah, okay. You're going first?
Raphael? It's up to you, bro.
You look a little nervous now.
Wait, how do we get him up higher for the camera?
Can he stand on a box?
I'm not even kidding.
Well, the phone camera, book? Can the camera be aimed?
No, because he's a little shorter, so we wanted to make sure.
Fella.
We want to make sure we get this on camera, that's all.
If I was in better shape, he could stand on my back.
All right, we are adjusting the webcam.
What's your phone book?
That's good.
The apparatus filled with, how many bees are in there, seriously? Would you guess?
Yeah, a shitload.
50? About 50 bees.
That's fine, they're not going to bother you.
Wait, and we need the camera where we see their faces, I think, too.
Yeah, raising it back up. We could still proceed here.
You don't bother them, they won't bother you.
Yeah, we need to see their face.
I might have to pull out then.
Yeah, pull out a little. Because we're getting video as well for the websites that will be close-ups and all that crap. Whatever way is most comfortable. We got a two-camera shoot happening.
Bill, did you just say whichever way is most comfortable?
None.
Whichever way is most comfortable.
And we need a girl to blow into the tube.
I think they're pretty.
Into the phallic okay. tube.
I don't think you need to.
Yeah, I think they're pretty angry.
Who's going to put their mouth by that tube?
Here we go. The ultimate challenge. We've been waiting 5 years to do this on
radio. 5 years in the
making. We finally found lawyers who are stupid enough to let us do this.
Oh, my God.
Gentlemen, take your balls out.
All right, let's explain.
Finally.
Oh. Raphael has
sticky balls.
Sticky balls, yes.
Yeah, they're sticky from the previous competition, which was the wax strip.
You don't have to worry about your penis head. None of us are looking at it from more than a few seconds.
Please, don't worry about it.
I don't think my balls are going to fit in the apparatus.
Well, it better. Yeah. You're going to have to jam them in there somehow.
They'll fit. Bill, push this ball.
They'll fit.
Bill, open up the rubber.
Force them in there. Be a man. What's
open up the rubber and
oh,
yeah.
Fuck. Just imagine.
Get him in there. Jam it in.
All right. Is it in there?
Yeah, it's sticking.
Who's looking?
Wait. Let your boss know who's boss.
Yeah, get the other side in. Don't drop it, whatever you do.
Yeah, hold it, dude. Don't drop it.
Shove it. I don't think you got enough sack in there.
Yeah, push more sack in there.
Push it up to the base of your, like, schlong.
Could somebody get a picture of the apparatus on? Because it's really fucking funny.
That's the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Can you get a shot of that?
Should we do one at a time or both?
Oh, my God.
All right, they're in there pretty good now, right?
Yes.
Do you have a good seal around your nuts so no bees are going to be jumping out?
Yes.
Dude, can you move your shirt? We can't see from the side at all. There
and
you go.
There's,
take your shirt off. It's cool.
There's nutsack. you can see what's going on in there.
Come on, I'm
going
to get fucking...
Nathaniel, get a long shot here from the side.
Jesus Christ. Oh, my God.
Raphael, smile for Nathaniel. He's
one more.
Yeah.
Make sure you hold on to that apparatus.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Is there any bag in there?
Yes.
Can I get signed copies of that?
Is there plenty of sack in there?
Yeah, there's more than
there's enough sack in there. Okay.
Right. Wait, Raphael, what are you thinking?
Yeah, right now, what are you thinking?
Obvious question. What are you thinking? Are you nervous? Be honest.
Oh, my God.
Fuck, let's just open it up and get it done with.
You're freaked out,
this
aren't
is
you?
The ultimate challenge. This is why we're all here today. So God.
This is the ultimate challenge.
Way to be a champion.
Ari is covering her face.
How do you use
all
this?
Right. The
Ari's
gate.
Doing that girl thing.
I don't know how the gate's open.
Like,
ask
through your fingers. I feel like I'm doing a
ask fantastic Bill how the gate gets open, because that looks like you're ready to open up
Bill?
The bottom of the container.
I push the plastic clear lever towards the nozzle front.
Shit. Toward the nozzle.
Towards push it down and towards.
You're going to have to jiggle it a little.
Yeah, it's
not too much. Jiggle the handle.
Push hard.
Oh,
don't break the thing.
No.
This is Bill's 4-H project.
I don't like this.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Yeah, don't pull the lid off.
Yeah, you're pulling the lid off. Bill, you're going to have to do it for
Bill,
him.
Bill, you're going to have to help him.
Just get in there,
yeah,
Bill.
Just be a trooper.
Put your gloves on. Grab a hold of that apparatus.
We are running out of show.
You're going to buy me new gloves after this.
We are running out of show.
Now, how long is this going to stay on my sack? Oh, shit.
There it goes.
All right.
Oh, they're in there.
All right. They're in. They're in. All right.
They're in there.
Do you
there.
Feel anything crawling on your sack yet?
I don't know. Maybe.
He doesn't know.
Holy shit, dude.
Are they on you?
They're tickling my bag.
Are you feeling kidding? On your bag?
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding.
They're on his bag.
There's bees on his balls.
Oh, my God. There's bees on his balls.
Oh, yes.
What?
Uh-oh.
What?
Jump up and down.
Yeah, give us a jump up and down.
Oh, my God.
Don't be a pussy.
Dude, this is fucking... This is crazy. Agitate him.
Yeah, just jump up and down. Just give it a big jump.
You mean it. Like your twitchels.
Boing!
Oh, God.
All right, we're just waiting now.
Can I just touch
yeah.
No!
I just want to rile him up a bit.
Yeah, rile him up a bit.
I think contestant number two ought to start preparing by getting
I think I just got... I think I just got stung.
Did you get stung?
I think so, yeah. Oh, yeah, I feel swelling.
You won't be able to get it out of the apparatus.
Fez will help.
Dude, this is fucking, this is crazy,
this
guys.
This is nuts. Are you tapping out or what?
No, I'm not tapping out.
I think we ought to get the other competitor ready.
Yeah, I say so, too. These guys aren't, this is nothing.
We don't want to run out of time.
Come on. Right.
Just leave your bag in there, let the bees crawl around.
Oh, what the...
All right, shove that up.
The feeling of the bee on my ball, like, walking around is just fucking unexplainable.
How about wasps?
Wow, he got his sack in there pretty quickly.
Wait, now you
got
to open up the thing.
Yeah, you got to open the gate.
Oh, God, they're tickling.
They're tickling? I think you're going to know when you get stung.
I think they're going to stick to the...
I think they're just nibbling.
They don't realize that there's a threat. It looks like another nest to them.
All right, Steve from Connecticut is trying to open up the hatch
sweaty, nervous
to release
nest.
The bees into the apparatus.
How come Bill could do it so easily?
He was testing this out. He was working on this apparatus all afternoon.
Bill.
Help him out.
Help him out. Help him out, son.
All right, Bill will release the bees.
Could you move the paper towel roll?
Oh, fuck.
Oh,
what happened? You getting stung?
Yeah.
But whoa!
Oh,
hold on, we got a break. He broke the tube.
Oh shit!
Hold up.
Oh, there's a breach.
Oh,
is the tube broke?
Yeah, the tube snapped off.
Don't let him out.
They're not coming out.
It's secure again.
Dude, you got stung?
I'm opening this first.
Oh, great.
There's less in here.
All right, he's opening them up.
Opening the gate first.
Master Poe is making a weapon. Right.
Stop it, Jimmy!
Jimmy started smacking me like I had a bee on me.
Fuck!
What happened?
You got stung?
Oh my God.
What honeybees stung? They're harmless.
What happened?
It's not opening.
It's just nature.
Oh!
What?
Mmm.
You having sex with the bee or what? Yeah.
Can't get that gate open? Damn it.
One of our apparatuses is busted.
Guy's waiting, balls in hand.
Oh, come on,
just
man.
A big sack of balls
just
hanging
a
around.
A handful of nutsack.
Oh, those bees are...
Here?
After all this shaking...
What happened, Bill?
Here we go.
All right, Bill.
There you go. Bill's good, man.
Bill's good. You
Bill's
got it, Bill.
Open.
All right.
Bill's a fucking professional.
Give him a second to...
All right, get your nuts in there. All right, oh, wow, there's bees in there already.
I definitely got
shove your nuts
twice.
In there.
Jesus, all right, he's shoving his nuts into the bee apparatus
no
thing.
No bees getting out. Ow.
This kid is
on. Steve is, Steve is already agitating the bees.
Fucking Steve is tapping them, daring
Steve
them.
Steve is tapping, he's daring them.
Now, do you have a good amount of sack in there?
Yeah, he's got
I
his.
See it
yeah,
hanging
there's
in there.
A lot of.
Dude, he's got a leg in there.
All right.
Not as much as I can get
now
in.
Now, lift
there.
Up the phallic-looking thing and tip it back so all the bees get in there.
Mm.
Did you get stung at all, Raphael?
Twice already, I swear to God.
Now, tap the bottom of your apparatus on the table.
Teabagging some bees. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Teabag a cup of coffee, not bees.
You want to tap the apparatus?
I think
you got to shake it to get them flying around a little.
I think one's licking my balls.
Licking?
Licking.
Bees have tongues?
Oh, there we go.
Are they on there?
What are they doing?
These suck.
What are they doing?
Nothing. They're just fucking hanging out.
I think you
got
to jump up and down.
Yeah,
and
you
got to
agitate.
Levitate.
There you go.
Yeah. Steve is rocking and rolling.
Oh, he's getting them.
Steve Jesus. Is jumping up and down a couple feet in the air.
And they're still just laying at the bottom all fucking...
Well, they probably can't breathe anymore.
Yeah.
Whoa.
That'll piss them off.
You feel them around your ball bag or anything?
No.
You should have painted your sack like a beautiful flower.
I can tea on my balls with sugar and shit. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Where are those wasps? You may need them.
And you got stung.
Twice.
Twice?
Yes.
Are they moving around your ball bag still?
They're walking around, definitely.
Fucking agitate them.
I did.
All right. Look
at this. Hey, I got stung twice, dear, with mother.
I'm trying to get stung, they won't let
oh,
me.
Oh, I see one walking up on the side.
Here we go.
Maybe he's getting closer. One was flying around in there.
I won't agitate them for a minute, see what they do.
They got to kind of get acclimated to their new surroundings. Perhaps that's it.
All right, they're,
That's how it worked for me.
Oh, one's crawling up the side again. Could be could make contact with your nuts soon.
Now, Opie, what I'm worried about is when I remove my bag from this
unit.
Yeah, we're
unit, all gonna
be worried. It's what we're all worried about.
That's why they got the bee suit.
My balls are sticky. I mentioned it several times.
So you think maybe a couple of bees might be stuck to your nuts?
Yes.
So we'll just swat them with
Well,
something.
You know what? We're running out of show, so we got to get Matt involved. So,
thank you.
Raphael, why don't you pass over the apparatus to Matt? Hopefully,
make sure the bees. How many
Nothing.
Bees are on your ball?
None.
EMT guys, check him out and see if he got stung or not.
What's that? Oh. It's a fucking pubic hair stuff.
What? You see him on the toilet all the time.
Yeah, pull off your pubic hair and pass on the apparatus.
I say the wasps. You gotta go for wasps. Yep. You gotta get the wasps.
Oh.
I don't know, just do it over the jar.
Matt's saying fuck it.
Matt's a fucking poof.
He is shaking him up. Watch the tube doesn't fall off of that one.
Yeah, let's be careful.
All right, now we're ready to roll.
Oh, yeah, they're rocking and rolling. Look at these. They're coming right up.
What happened?
Huh? You might have. The bees might have suffocated.
Did it.
All right, here we go. Matt is throwing his ball bag into the apparatus with the bees.
Get the wasp.
A nice contraption.
Very well thought out, yeah.
What the fuck?
All right, he's trying to squeeze his ball
I'm
bag
in there.
I'm a
little trouble.
They didn't bother you, huh, Steve?
No, hold up.
Oh, my God.
Watch the, don't flip, pull that tube out. Oh, he's shaking him up now. Get him all angry.
Hoo-hoo, he's copying off of me, shaking him.
You gotta get him up by your...
fucking break.
You're dead.
No, they're not. They're all now. They're fucking, look at them.
They're moving. Dead.
This whole thing has literally left me speechless. Literally.
Yeah,
I'm like trying to think of something. It's like, it's actually taken all the words out of my head.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Will blowing into them help?
No, most of them are lying on their back. They're not doing anything.
All right, well, they're fucking...
All right, Matt's
sacked.
What? You get bitten, Matt?
No.
Matt is, Matt's got the apparatus on. He's moving the apparatus. He's trying to agitate the bees.
Bees are fucking creeps.
All right.
I got a wasp. I got two wasps. You want to bring them in?
Yeah, bring in the wasps.
All right, let's see if we can get... I just got mine in.
Right. Yeah, well, Matt, you can keep yours on.
Ooh.
There's nothing worse than a wasp.
Poe, when you open that lid, don't let him fly out.
Yeah.
Oh, here they come.
Here they come, Matt.
Oh, they're pissed.
Yeah? Here they come.
See them?
Yeah, they're all over the... they're moving up the wall of the apparatus.
No, you should just put the ball... No, leave the wasps in the jar. They should put his balls over that jar, Poe.
Leave them in the jar.
What's that?
Leave them in the jar, dude.
We can see it, and we can just put it... You can just keep...
Put his balls in there. Don't dump them in there.
So Ari's got to go.
Guys, I'm going to head out.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you so much for having me here. And
we'll have you back again.
We'll have you back because it was a wild
I hope
wild
your balls are okay.
For this.
Right. Oh, they're on me. They're on me.
All right, they're walking on you.
Don't
now.
Dump them, Poe, because they might start.
It's the most action I got in 6 months.
Thank you, Ari.
Bye, guys. Bye.
Dog sees God. DogSeesGod.com for information. Yeah. All right.
I'd like to say thank you to Master Poe for pissing these wasps off.
Yeah, dude, put the ball. There's only one wasp in each one.
We only have 5 minutes of show left. 5 minutes of show.
I just put them.
It's only one.
Oh, what happened?
Nothing. There's like four of them on me.
Crawling on your.
There's
four on your nutsack.
Wasp, and let's see who can go the longest.
Yeah, champ.
How about that belt?
Do the wasp.
Wow.
Where's Raphael?
Getting checked out.
Okay, he's fine. All right, put your ball in the wasp.
He's fine. Just got stung twice in the nutsack.
What do you want me to do?
Are we going to go head-to-head with each other?
No, guys, we are running out of show, so we don't have time to do much of anything.
Right in. And just make sure you get a nice seal.
Watch out.
Oh, shit.
Get a nice seal there.
Oh, ow.
All right, I got stung, yeah.
Did you get stung?
Oh, no.
Yeah. Where?
A wasp crawling by the wall.
It's coming up.
You got stung in the sack?
Yeah.
And now the wasp is... The wasp is now making its way up the jar.
Yes.
Oh, God.
Wait, this is in the way here.
Oh, no. How close is the wasp?
Oh, shit. I can feel him feeling on my nut. Like, his feelers coming around and he walks away.
Jumping, yeah.
Matt is jumping up and down. He's got a wasp in a jar.
Jesus Christ.
That's sick. Is he on your ball bag?
Now I was walking back.
They're trying to get stung in the balls by a wasp.
Yeah.
They're attempting. The wasp is disappointing them by his lack of willingness to sting their testicles.
Can I have the jars when you're done? I'm making jelly later.
Sure, Fez. I'll sign my jar for you after the show. There we go.
Hello. Oh,
yeah, here he comes.
Boy, are you pissing that thing off.
Hello. Hello.
Is he up on your sack?
He's right under my fucking sack.
Oh, goddamn.
Come on, you fucking cunt.
Wow.
Excuse my English.
Dirty talking.
Sorry,
yeah. These wasps suck.
We need more vicious bugs.
Let's try this in the spring.
Where'd you get these fucking bees from? Berkeley? What are you doing, bro? Oh,
he's really just fucking up the wasps. Shaking it up.
What happens if they get on their backs and let the wasp fall onto them so that it's
good grabs? You know what, Bill? You raise an excellent point. Someone quick, up on the console on your back. Fuck it. I'm not kidding.
All right, what does he got? What do you got?
These are four.
Oh! Jesus Christ! What? Oh, holy shit!
Hey,
holy shit!
Good save.
Hey, Champ.
That came out of nowhere!
Hey, Champ, why don't you take that one?
Holy
shit! No, Poe, leave it like that, Poe. Champ.
Holy shit!
Why don't you take that one? He's obviously a fucking... He's no longer playing games.
Did you see him jump, Anthony?
He's the champion.
Holy shit.
He pops into the top.
Wait, where's that...
Not yet.
Kill him.
No. What am I going to do?
Where's that last jar?
That's what I'm
giving
him.
Oh, there you go. Okay, he's got the pissed off wasp. He's got the pissed off wasp. Is he going right for the nut? Oh, God damn it.
Oh, my God.
That just ain't right. Yeah,
that guy,
Steve jumped like I've never seen anyone jump before in my life. Oh, my God.
Who brought another jar in? What was in the other jar?
Four small paper wasps that I'm shaking up vigorously.
You want to go for the four paper wasps?
Sure. Whatever's
four.
Fucking going to get me
started. That one wasp seemed really pissed.
No, this wasp has a taste for it now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh my God. He's no.
That's how it works.
God damn it. No, not that
not
jar.
The nest. Not the nest.
Plug it up. That thing is going to...
Nest. 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 Oh, no. Nest.
No. Nest. Oh, God. I'm petrified.
With a wasp nest.
We got it. We got a minute. We only have a minute left in the show. A minute left in the show.
Oh, he's going with the entire
a minute left in the show.
Holy shit.
When the show ends, just end it, because we can't get plugs or anything.
Plug that shit up.
We only have a minute left in the show. Can we go a little long? Is it possible to... No, we can't go long.
No, it cuts off and it'll go right to...
All right, we got a minute 15. Matt has put the jar that has the nest of bees.
Don't drop it if you get stung.
Don't drop it.
Holy shit.
Jump up and down.
Jump up and down. This is the grand finale. Matt, the current ball champion.
He has his balls for the wasp nest.
He's got his balls in a jar that has a little wasp nest.
Wow.
Anything? Any 50 seconds.
They're on it.
Here they come.
They're on it. They're on it.
Here they come.
Oh, shit.
Here they come. Please don't drop. We have 40 seconds left in the show. He is basically shaking the jar upside down right onto his nutsack.
Oh, God damn it. Oh, you put the entire nest against his sack.
It's
oh, my God. The whole nest is against his sack.
30 seconds left in the show.
What courage.
30 seconds. The cameras are rolling. Oh, my God. This is for the title, Matt.
You
for
are
the title.
A madman.
All right. Oh,
oh,
my God.
Get the jar again.
Where's the cover?
Put the
cover.
Give him the cover. Give him the cover.
Give him the cover.
Give him the cover. Don't spray his balls. Give him the cover.
Give him
the fucking cover.
Program complete.